Well, hello and welcome. It is good to be back at Prairie Grove for some more basketball action for your Prairie Grove Tigers. I'm Stephen Blackston. Lynn will be with us momentarily. Just want to let you know that we will be having the Colors Day recognition at Prairie Grove shortly for tonight's game between Gravette and your Prairie Grove Tigers. Stick with us here on the Southern Sports Network. We will bring you Colors Day, the girls' varsity game, and the boys' varsity game after these messages.
Auto and Farm Supply is an independently owned and operated Carquest Auto Parts store, a family-owned mom-and-pop business that's been servicing this community since 1983. They can source auto parts from Carquest and Advanced Auto Warehouses, receiving shipments 5 nights a week. For all your auto parts needs, or if you just want to come down and drink some coffee with the old guys, come see Larry and Karen and the dog Rosie at 119 East Buchanan Street, historic downtown Prairie Grove.
Dumpster Divers LLC is a local family business serving your disposal needs since 2010. We are licensed haulers providing 15-yard dumpsters with prompt and friendly service. Please call us today for a free quote at 479-966-5878. Please like and share us on Facebook. We look forward to serving you soon.
Hi, my name is Jackson, and my family owns Faithful Auto in Farmington, and we love Jesus. Being upfront and honest are part of our core values. You can come see us for your complete auto care. We offer computer diagnostics, brake work, air conditioning service and repair, front end and oil changes. By the way, our computer system uploads your maintenance records to Carfax, so you can take super good care of your car. Have you been in a fender bender? Let us do your collision repair. We're open Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, so call for an appointment. We're proud to support the Prairie Grove Tigers. Go Tigers!
Harton Furniture is conveniently located on Highway 62 between Prairie Grove and Farmington. Terry Harton carries staple brands such as Mayo, Best Chair, Ashley, Rustonic, and Vaughn Bassett. Terry has over 20 years of experience in the furniture business, and he works hard to keep a well-stocked inventory, but has many more options available through custom orders. So come by and see Terry Harton at Harton's Furniture for all your furniture needs. He'll treat you right.
Statistics show out of 3 million people in Arkansas, 55% do not attend church on a weekly basis. We value the Word of God in our services. We strive to present it in a practical and engaging way. This is a place where you can belong even before you believe. We will accept you as you are, but we will give you the practical steps to encourage and develop you on your pathway to Christ. We are here for you every step of the way. We'll save a seat for you.
Zing Broadband is a proud sponsor of area schools and is excited.
Thank you. May Emery Gunther. She's the daughter of Johnny and Shanna Gunther. Emery is escorted by Eric Henderson, son of Robert and Amy Henderson, and Austin Henry, son of Glenn and Lily Norwood.
Julie Dobbs and Brandon Boland.
Romans, and Darby Gunther, son of Johnny and Shannon Gunther. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2023 Cubs Day Corps. We will allow 5 minutes for pictures.
Auto and Farm Supply is an independently owned and operated CarQuest Auto Parts store, a family-owned mom-and-pop business that's been servicing this community since 1983. They can source auto parts from CarQuest and Advanced Auto Warehouses, receiving shipments 5 nights a week. For all your auto parts needs, or if you just want to come down and drink some coffee with the old guys, come see Larry and Karen and the dog Rosie at 119 East Buchanan Street, historic downtown Prairie Grove.
Dumpster Divers LLC is a local family business serving your disposal needs since 2010. We are licensed haulers providing 15-yard dumpsters with prompt and friendly service. Please call us today for a free quote at 479-966-5878. Please like and share us on Facebook. We look forward to serving you soon.
Hi, my name is Jackson, and my family owns Faithful Auto in Farmington, and we love Jesus. Being upfront and honest are part of our core values. You can come see us for your complete auto care. We offer computer diagnostics, brake work, air conditioning service and repair, front end and oil changes. By the way, our computer system uploads your maintenance records to Carfax, so you can take super good care of your car. Have you been in a fender bender? Let us do your collision repair. We're open Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, so call for an appointment. We're proud to support the Prairie Grove Tigers. Go Tigers!
Harden Furniture is conveniently located on Highway 62 between Prairie Grove and Farmington. Terry Harden carries staple brands such as Mayo, Best Chair, Ashley, Rustonic, and Vaughn Bassett. Terry has over 20 years of experience in the furniture business, and he works hard to keep a well-stocked inventory, but has many more options available through custom orders. So come by and see Terry Harden at Harden's Furniture for all your furniture needs. He'll treat you right.
Statistics show out of 3 million people in Arkansas, 55% do not attend church on a weekly basis. We value the Word of God in our services. We strive to present it in a practical and engaging way. This is a place where you can belong even before you believe. We will accept you as you are, but we will give you the practical steps to encourage and develop you on your pathway to Christ. We are here for you every step of the way. We'll save a seat for you.
Zing Broadband is a proud sponsor of area schools and is excited to offer incredible fast internet speeds. Our students can focus on what really matters, knowing that Zing Broadband can keep up with them. We recognize the hard work and dedication of our students and athletes, and we've built a network to deliver their demand. Zing Broadband proudly serves our local communities and supports all their endeavors.
Kimball Mechanical Systems specializes in installing plumbing, HVAC, and electrical systems in mid to large housing projects, including subdivisions, apartment complexes, and military housing. Kimball wants to partner with more people who want to earn a good living in the skilled trades. Kimball is the largest mechanical contractor in Arkansas with 8 other locations nationwide. Kimball is proud to have won Arkansas's Best Places to Work 5 years in a row. They provide excellent benefits and an amazing family-oriented culture. For great job opportunities, check out KMSJobs.com.
Thank you. Kimball Mechanical Systems specializes in installing plumbing, HVAC, and electrical systems in mid to large housing projects, including subdivisions, apartment complexes, and military housing. Kimball wants to partner with more people who want to earn a good living in the skilled trades. Kimball is the largest mechanical contractor in Arkansas with 8 other locations nationwide. Kimball is proud to have won Arkansas's Best Places to Work 5 years in a row. They provide excellent benefits and an amazing family-oriented culture. For great job opportunities, check out kmsjobs.com.
Auto and Farm Supply is an independently owned and operated CarQuest Auto Parts store, a family-owned mom-and-pop business that's been servicing this community since 1983. They can source auto parts from CarQuest and Advanced Auto Warehouses, receiving shipments 5 nights a week. For all your auto parts needs, or if you just want to come down and drink some coffee with the old guys, come see Larry and Karen and the dog Rosie at 119 East Buchanan Street, historic downtown Prairie Grove.
Welcome to Prairie Grove Tiger Arena for tonight's basketball contest in the 4A1 between the Gravette Lions and our Prairie Grove Tigers. Tonight is Colors Day. We congratulate, it was Kinley Elder, wasn't it, as our queen, and we congratulate her and her family. And because of Colors Day, Stephen, we will be having the boys game first and then the girls game second. I'm Lynn Gregson, with me, Stephen Blackiston. Stephen, in tonight's contest, this is, I think, coming into this game, both boys and girls both, I think, are very evenly matched teams. I don't like to compare scores because when you do, but record-wise, teams that they've played and how they fared against them are very similar. And I think the bad thing is our boys have played okay at times, but on a losing streak. Yeah. And really need something tonight maybe to turn that around.
No, I agree 100%, Lynn. And, yes, my name's Steven, not Ryan Cook. I know we sound alike. For those at home, to end that debate, we're two separate people, even though we've never been seen in the same place at the same time, but we're two separate people. Yeah, no, I agree, Lynn. Though for the boys of Prairie Grove, they come in tonight 1-4. Gravette comes in 2-3 in the 4A1. It's definitely a winnable game for the hometown Tigers. Going to need a big night. From lots of the starters, a lot of the seniors, Benoit, I'd like to see him step up.
And I think that's the – I think between him and Edmondson, I mean, you know, there's going to be times, a lot of times, when Henderson will get streaky. And so you can kind of – you know that he'll have a few threes. But you're going to need Edmondson. You're going to need Benoit. You're going to need those guys. We're going to go to the PA for the starting lineups, and we'll be back for the game after the starting lineups.
Now for our starting line. First for the visiting Gravette Lions, number 3, Gunnar Wolf. Number 5, Logan Betts. Number 12, Isaiah Larson. Number 22, Will Betts. And number 33, Kais Patton. The Lions are coached by Matt Bush. And now for your hometown, Prairie Grove Tigers. Number 3, Eric Henderson. Number 4, Sam Kidd. Number 5, Tate Benoit. Number 13, Jace Edwards. And number 15, Cole Edmiston. Tigers.
All right. All right, Steven, I'm excited about tonight because, you know, Colors Day always brings a little bit bigger crowd. You got a pretty big student section tonight. Pep band is playing loud. It's not quite as loud as it was in Bud Walton on Wednesday night, but we'll take it. Bud Walton was loud Wednesday night till about 4 minutes to go in the game.
Yeah, then it got ultimately quiet over there down the road at the Basketball Palace of Mid-America, but no, I think the students of Prairie Grove are going to make Tiger Gym a little bit hostile tonight against the Gravette Lions.
Well, so if we keep it close, I think it'll be a night like that. If it, you know, if it gets away, I think as long as it stays close, you're going to have that that crowd participation, and that can really be a big difference in a basketball game of momentum. The tap is going to go to Kidd. Henderson's got it, and we are underway here on Colors Night. Benoit with the ball there on the arm. Trying to get it inside to Edmiston, does. Now Edmiston posting up, kicks it back out. Edwards, Henderson thought about that three, pulls up, jumper, no good. Rebound goes into the hands of the Gravette Lions, and that is Patton. And bringing the ball down for Gravette. Number 3, Gunnar Woolard.
And not a bad look the first time down the floor for the Prairie Grove Tigers. You got a mid-range jumper, fairly better shot than taking a contested three. We'll see if the Tigers can play defense the other end of the floor as both teams await in that first basket.
Try to get it inside. Nice job. Really nice job that time by Edmiston to deny Patton the ball. Now, Patton's a pretty good size. He and Edmiston are probably close in height, but I'd say he's got about 15 or 20 on Cole.
Yeah, I would agree. Able to get that ball inbounded to him, but not able to put the shot up and in. Tigers going to run out the other way.
Got it down there quickly. Edwards with the ball. There's Benoit and Kidd. Trying to get it. Edmiston gets it inside. Nice give and go. And in! Hey, that's the way to get it started. All right, Kidd gets fouled, so he's going to go for the old-fashioned three. And Woodard picks up the fouls. Kidd, nice take that time by Kidd.
Certainly is. Nice little give-and-go action, able to get it to go. Can't get the free one to fall at the line. That's been an issue throughout the season for Prairie Grove, but you'll be proud with the first basket and hope more come in the coming minutes.
Oh, Edmiston, lucky he didn't get a foul on that. When you sling that arm like that, oftentimes they'll call it. No call that time. And Woolard makes up for his foul by getting the first basket for the Gravette Lions. All tied up at 2. 6 minutes, 10 seconds to go here, first quarter. Edmiston almost loses it. And they'll reset it. 15 seconds still on the shot clock. Kidd's going to bring it back up to the top of the key. Down to 8 seconds. Got to do a little something here. Kidd, a little floater, short. Gets his own rebound. Kicks it out. Edmiston. Oh, started to take that long three.
Yeah, he could have stepped into that one, had a little bit of space from Patton coming out on the rotation, but that's not, I think, where Edmondson likes to live.
Bottom! Hey! I don't know if Edmondson likes to live with that long of a three, but he'll take that one.
Yeah, Henderson, he wears number three for a reason. He's got the ultra green light. We've seen that throughout this 2022-2023 season. And that's the first three-pointer of the day for either side.
And there, the Tigers with the ball, and Henderson. I don't know if he's got the ultimate green light. I think he runs a stop sign every now and then. Nice take by Edmondson. Oh, unable to convert. That was a good move by Cole.
Yeah, certainly taking Patton off the dribble. I think that Patton is more comfortable in the post-defense mode, not on a dribble defender.
In and out, no good that time from Woolard. And now Edwards brings it down. I think Cole, speed-wise, can go one-on-one against Patton. And he probably could do that getting down there low and using a good footwork. There's another three. No good. Can't stand around looking at it, guys. Go get it, and they do. Edmondson thought about that three. Henderson looking, and now Edwards. And he trying to force the action, and he gets it.
That's a tough basket. Absorb the contact, put it up and in. But to your point, Lynn, about the battle we're going to see between Edmondson and Patton tonight, I'll be curious to see as we keep going up and down the floor. They keep bringing Patton out to that three-point line when Edmondson goes in motion if he doesn't get into his legs later on in this game.
Nice take that time. A little confusing there on the Tiger defense as Betts gets his first basket and makes it 7-4. Tigers lead the Lions. And there it is. Should be an easy basket for Edmondson. It is. Nice job. Good ball movement that time as the Tigers go back up five. What I like right now is there's been four baskets by four different guys.
And, you know, the only one to score, so not yet to score for Prairie Grove. Benoit is the ninja on the team, the hustle player on the team, and he'll get his baskets later on. But he's doing a lot off the ball at the moment, setting up his teammates.
Betts is going to get that offensive foul, and now coming into the game is Alex Henry. Alex Henry, I do it every week. Austin Henry, I do it every single week. I'm so used to Nacho Man. It's Austin Henry, Austin Henry, Austin Henry.
I'm going to have to put a little jar out here and start paying you a dollar every time. I might end up going home pretty wealthy at the end of the season.
You could. There's Henderson, three, bottom. He's got two already. Hey! 12-4, a nice lead for the Tigers to start off. We're not even at the three-minute mark. Tigers up eight. Woolard, he gives up to Betts, back to Woolard. Woolard doesn't like. There he goes, and a nice shot. Willard looks like he's got the green light as well as Willard hits the three, makes it 12-7.
Yeah, Willard has 5 of the 7 points for Prairie Grove, or for Gravette, excuse me, so far. So it'll be interesting to see an adjustment if that can be made to stop the Lions' leading scorer.
Nice hustle that time by Patton, but he's unable to keep it, and the Tigers will retain possession. 2:40 to go here in the first quarter, and the Tigers lead it 12-7. One of the better starts that we've had this season, Stephen.
No, I would agree 100%. You know, normally on a high school basketball evening, it's the women of Prairie Grove first, but maybe there might be something to the men's team coming out first. Get the nerves out early. Don't have to sit and think about it. Just attack.
We're down to 8 seconds on the shot clock. Got to do something here. Kidd drives, kicks it out. Henry, no good. Rebound's going to go to Edmondson, so we'll start that shot clock again. And a nice take by Kidd. Look at Kidd. Kidd's being the kid tonight. 14-7.
That kid can play. Nice little nifty move up off the glass. High percentage look at the basket, and you've doubled up Gravette in this first quarter. It's a great start.
And there he goes with a three again. This time off the back rim. Benoit, nice rebound. The Tigers with it with 1:50 to go, leading 14-7.
The kid got lucky that time down the floor on that three-point shot. Thought about getting his hand up. A lot of times you don't get that hand in the shooter's face. It'll be an easy three-pointer.
Wow, there's another foul, and it's going to be on zero. That's DeWitt. Sam DeWitt with that foul. Now that's three team fouls already on the Lions. Tigers, no foul so far, which is unusual.
It certainly is. Nice clean open to this first quarter.
Benoit gives it up to Henry. Henry Edmonston. Faked his own man out there. What? One thing about Woolard, he can create his shot. I noticed that, you know, a lot of times guys just take a bad shot. He was contested that time, but he still got a good shot off. He kind of creates his own shot.
Yeah, I would agree. I would like to see, you know, if you're the coach of Gravette, I would assume, you know, at least one or two passes when you go down the floor. But Woolard goes straight on the attack to make a basket happen, and it's a quick possession, and it's a rebound back to Prairie Grove.
There is Evans to miss the shot. Number 22 on the shot, no good. Wow, he almost made a liar out of me. That's Betts. And so Tigers now just about 5 seconds differential between the game clock and the play clock. Tigers leading 14-7. And now, boy, Henderson almost took that deep three.
He's known to take it.
Oh. That was the right look. Everything just a bad pass. It's almost like having a guy wide open in end zone and missing him. That's kind of what that was.
No, I would agree there 100%. But there was something on that possession just to keep an eye on. Like I mentioned earlier, Edmondson's coming out to set that screen, and it's forcing Patton to come out and pick it up. We'll see if Patton can continue to do that over the course of the night as a post player. Obviously, your conditioning is not going to be as good as some of these faster guards.
No good. Woolard hits the three, and you can't leave him open. And he closes that gap, which was as much as 8, down to 4. After one quarter play, it's Prairie Grove 14. Gravette 10, back after this.
Auto and Farm Supply is an independently owned and operated CarQuest auto parts store, a family-owned mom-and-pop business that's been servicing this community since 1983. They can source auto parts from CarQuest and Advanced Auto Warehouses, receiving shipments 5 nights a week. For all your auto parts needs, or if you just want to come down and drink some coffee with the old guys, come see Larry and Karen and the dog Rosie at 119 East Buchanan Street, historic downtown Prairie Grove.
All right, we're back. And nice cut. And a nice take. Good strong move inside by Gravette Lions. That's number 32, Munoz. And Munoz cuts the lead to 2.
Yeah, Munoz coming in off the bench with a couple of other substitutes from Gravette to start the second quarter. Nice little hook shot in for him.
That's what we need to do right there. I think Edmonston on both Munoz and Patton can do that. I think he's got the speed a little bit quicker than both of those guys. I think that's a matchup tonight that we can take advantage of.
No, 100%. I agree with you, Lynn. Edmonston, I think, yeah, like you said, a little bit faster, a little bit better natural shooter than the other posts of Gravette.
Well, that time, Woolard's unable to convert. 16-12, Tigers lead. Henry brings it down. Wow, stolen. It's going to be.
That's an NBA continuation there.
Yeah, if you're going to. That's if you're going to foul there, which he intentionally fouled him, he really did. You got to come down on that arm so he can't take it up.
No, I agree with you there. And Willard, I mean, it's basically for Gravette at the moment, it's the Gunnar Willard show. He has 11 of the 15.
Yeah, 11 of the 15 right now. And he cut the lead down to one. It was as big as eight. So give the Gravette Lions a lot of credit for overcoming that initial onslaught. There is Henry, no good. Rebound goes into the hands of Gravette. That is Betts. And now Gravette can take their lead with that shot, and he does it. Man, I'll tell you what, Willard hits the three. He's got 14 of the 18.
Hey, Gunnar Willard's come locked and loaded off the bus from Gravette.
Well, the thing about Willard is, like I said, he can create his own shot. There's Henderson, bottom.
That's a big answer.
It is. It's 19-18. Shot on the way, contested, no good. Good position that time. And nice position that time by Munoz. He gets the basket, makes it 20-19.
That's a tough basket going back up with a couple of sets of hands in your face.
He did a nice job getting the offensive rebound. He had good position. And now, Benoit, it's Henderson, three, off, no good. Munoz rebound, quickly coming down the court is Betts. And Betts, whoa, what was that? About four or five steps, but there's a three-pointer made by Betts. That's Will Betts. There's a hold Betts and a Will Betts. And Betts hits the three, 23-19.
It's raining threes at the moment.
And a nice move by Henderson. And Henderson now with 11 in the game. That's his first two-pointer, 23-21. I'll tell you what, he's just dominating inside. Munoz just dominating inside the glass. He picks up another basket he's got 6 points this quarter.
Yeah, he's got three offensive rebounds down on this end of the floor and three buckets to show for it. It's right now, it's the Munoz and Willard show for Gravette.
Oh, he turned the opposite way. He's going to get fouled. Oh, no. Wow. I don't know if you saw that. He turned to his left. He turns to his right. He's got a wide open shot.
And that's something I think Coach Ed is going to pass along to his son there on the sidelines. He checks out.
25-21.
Had the opportunity, but still within touching distance of Gravette at the moment.
And I think that's what you're going to have to do is really stay tight on Willard. And there's a three-pointer again. That's Will Betts. He's got two threes. Now, what was an 8-point lead for Prairie Grove is now a 7-point lead for the Lions. And they've just gotten hot. Henderson for three short. And, wow, kid gets the rebound. Now gets it inside. Wow.
In college, that would be a restricted arc violation, I think, that being that deep down under the basket, of course, that not in high school. Maybe in, you know, 5 more years, 10 more years, we'll get that to the high school game since we just got the shot clock.
Corbin Bolin is the big man inside now for Prairie Grove. He's a center for the Tigers on the football team. And there's that step back shot. Good. And I'll tell you what, Willard, that guy can flat out shoot.
Yeah, he's singeing the twine off the goals here at Tiger Gym.
17 points for him out of 31. It's 31-21. Tigers need a basket. And need a run, really. And Kidd takes it, shot, no good. Put back up and in by Henderson.
Yeah, it was a weird-looking shot that time from Sam Kidd, but Henderson was in just the right spot.
So 31-23. And I think Coach Ed, that even though he got the basket there, I think that's a pretty good timeout. You don't want this thing to get out of hand. And that was one of the things I noticed. We were talking about Bud Walton the other night. I was at the arena, and what was so interesting about that game is that place was loud. Arkansas pulled within two. It was 4:45 to go in the quarter, Stephen, and most coaches will wait for that TV timeout. Mm-hmm. Nate Oates at Alabama decided, I'm going to take – and he took it, and then he strung off three threes by the four-minute mark. So, what – you know, you think of little things like that, and that was a big deal in that game.
I won't ask you who you're rooting
for.
No,
I actually it was a really good game.
Good answer. No, I agree with you on that front. And that's one of the nice things about college basketball. You know, every 4 minutes in the halves, you get a media timeout. You can reset. You can kind of play that to your advantage. But, you know, today in high school action, well, it looks like it's a turnover somewhere in there. It'll be Prairie Grove basketball. Okay.
I don't know how that happened. Didn't we just score?
They did. They put the basket on the –
they got it on the floor. I don't know how we got the ball.
I think – because I remember they got the ball inbounds and then the whistle came. I think, yeah, the inbounder for Gravette was inbounds, was past the baseline and committed the violation. Don't see that happen too often. Put that one on your high school basketball bingo card.
Whoa. We almost didn't get back inside. Turn the other way. Oh. Plenty of time on the shot clock still. Henderson, three. No good. Rebound goes in the hand of Munoz. Munoz made a difference since he's been in the game.
He certainly has. He's played quite better than the starting post player in Patton of Gravette. Comes in and has made quite the impact.
It's mostly – there's another three. That one's short. But there he is again with a rebound, offensive rebound. He misses that time, and Prairie Grove gets a break because it could have been a foul there. Tigers get a break on that.
I think that's the first basket that Munoz has missed.
On the putback, yeah, I believe you're right.
But he's got four offensive boards down here on this end and 6 points to show for it. I think Prairie Grove fans should be awfully happy that he's coming out of the ballgame to take a rest.
Let's see who they bring in, number 35. That's Beaver.
We'll see if they leave it to Beaver for Gravette on the offensive end.
Nicely done. Wow. Down to 14 seconds on the shot clock. Floater, no good. Rebound goes into the hands of Woolard. Watch Woolard. I think he'll pull up and shoot. He does. Shot. This time misses. Rebound goes to Henderson. Minute 25 to go. Tigers need to close it here with a couple baskets.
100%. Looks like Gravette and the coaching staff of the Lions are quite content with Woolard just to go down and shoot from wherever he wants to.
And the way he shot,
I'd let him.
Kid gets it. There is Edmonston. And Edmonston cuts that down to 31-25. And Prairie Grove will get the ball one more time. So a defensive stop here. And a shot on the way. And they're going to call that.
It's just been one of those nights for Gunnar Woolard, I suppose.
Woolard now with 19 in the game. He makes this, it'll be 20. And it is, misses it. Wow. 33-25. Benoit's been kind of quiet tonight.
He certainly has. Just hasn't seen the ball a lot on the evening, and that's just sometimes how the ball bounces.
Coach Ed's wanting the foul, and I agree with him on that one. I thought there was a little bit of hack going on. He's been in his ear, and he should be. And now they're going to get a – wow. Coach Ed's not going to be happy about that because, one, he thought he should have got a foul, and then they call that. I felt like Wooler was a little bit out of control on that one.
No, I'd agree. And it's also – it's coming from, you know, the back official as well, who's away from the play. That one always grinds your gears as a coach, and Coach Ed going to just go over and ask for an explanation.
And that one falls for Wooler. Now 20 points in the game. He's 2 of 3 from the line. Willard's second shot on the way, 5.3 seconds. And he gets that one to roll. So 3 of 4 from the line, 5-3 left. Need to get it down to court quick. Lays it up. Oh, no good. After one half of play, it's Gravette 35, Prairie Grove 25. Enjoy the halftime festivities.
Auto and Farm Supply is an independently owned and operated CarQuest auto parts store, a family-owned mom-and-pop business that's been servicing this community since 1983. They can source auto parts from CarQuest and Advanced Auto Warehouses, receiving shipments 5 nights a week. For all your auto parts needs, or if you just want to come down and drink some coffee with the old guys, come see Larry and Karen and the dog Rosie at 119 East Buchanan Street, historic downtown Prairie Grove.
Dumpster Divers LLC is a local family business serving your disposal needs since 2010. We are licensed haulers providing 15-yard dumpsters with prompt and friendly service. Please call us today for a free quote at 479-966-5878. Please like and share us on Facebook. We look forward to serving you soon.
Hi, my name is Jackson, and my family owns Faithful Auto in Farmington, and we love Jesus. Being upfront and honest are part of our core values. You can come see us for your complete auto care. We offer computer diagnostics, brake work, air conditioning service and repair, front end and oil changes. By the way, our computer system uploads your maintenance records to Carfax, so you can take super good care of your car. Have you been in a fender bender? Let us do your collision repair. We're open Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, so call for an appointment. We're proud to support the Prairie Grove Tigers. Go Tigers!
Harton Furniture is conveniently located on Highway 62 between Prairie Grove and Farmington. Terry Harton carries staple brands such as Mayo, Best Chair, Ashley, Restonic, and Vaughn Bassett. Terry has over 20 years of experience in the furniture business, and he works hard to keep a well-stocked inventory, but has many more options available through custom orders. So come by and see Terry Harton at Harton's Furniture for all your furniture needs. He'll treat you right.
Statistics show out of 3 million people in Arkansas, 55% do not attend church on a weekly basis. We value the Word of God in our services. We strive to present it in a practical and engaging way. This is a place where you can belong even before you believe. We will accept you as you are, but we will give you the practical steps to encourage and develop you on your pathway to Christ. We are here for you every step of the way. We'll save a seat for you.
Zing Broadband is a proud sponsor of area schools and is excited to offer incredible fast internet speeds. Our students can focus on what really matters, knowing that Zing Broadband can keep up with them. We recognize the hard work and dedication of our students and athletes, and we've built a network to deliver their demand. Zing Broadband proudly serves our local communities and supports all their endeavors.
Kimball Mechanical Systems specializes in installing plumbing, HVAC, and electrical systems in mid to large housing projects, including subdivisions, apartment complexes, and military housing. Kimball wants to partner with more people who want to earn a good living in the skilled trades. Kimball is the largest mechanical contractor in Arkansas with 8 other locations nationwide. Kimball is proud to have won Arkansas's Best Places to Work 5 years in a row. They provide excellent benefits and an amazing family-oriented culture. For great job opportunities, check out kmsjobs.com.
Wow, Steven, that halftime went by quick.
It certainly did kind of snuck. It's been a fast night, it feels like, with having Colors Day earlier on, having the court out on the floor. But, yeah, no, it certainly, the halftime went quick. Those first two quarters went quick. Not a lot of stoppages either side. Not a lot of fouls, and we get back underway. And, you know, Prairie Grove has a 10-point mountain to climb, but certainly we've seen in that first quarter that it's doable for the Prairie Grove Tigers with a three on the way that just misses off the mark for Eric Henderson. You know, we mentioned it a lot, Lynn, in the first and second quarters, that it's been the Gunner Woolard show, and, you know, he heaves up a circus shot there, doesn't get the whistle he wants, as I think he might have been trying to fish for something. But, you know, he's got 21 points. He's nearly outscoring Prairie Grove on his own account with five other guys on the floor. But, you know, Prairie Grove's been able to withstand the first salvo. Henderson will bring it back up across the line, waiting for the motion from the screen of Edmonston. Prairie Grove just trying to work it around inside. And we'll have a whistle and a timeout. Coach Ed, I think, wasn't happy with the offensive set. Might have been a bit of miscommunication. We'll keep it here. Still going to be Prairie Grove basketball. 14 seconds on the shot clock. As we've played about 45 seconds in this third quarter. Of course, we'll have the women's game following this one, a little bit different. Like we mentioned at the beginning of the broadcast, tonight is Colors Night. So we had the Colors Court. Some of the girls on the women's basketball team are on the court, so just give them a little bit of extra time to get changed and ready for their game against Gravette. Both these teams coming into tonight looking to claw their way up the conference ranks. 2-3 at Gravette, 1-4 for Prairie Grove. We're back underway, Lynn, and nobody's scored yet in this second half.
Well, it's just been one of these, you know, just trying to fill out here in the second half. Prairie Grove needs a run. If they fall behind further, I think Gravette, there's Eric, nice job, and he gets away just as the shot clock was about to expire. So Henderson now with 15 in the game. And I was saying is that I think Gravette has the shooters that if Prairie Grove were to fall back further, I think it's going to be hard to climb out. Prairie Grove needs to slow down. They got to slow down Woolard and let the other guys beat you.
Yeah, no, 100%. I imagine that'll be the halftime message from Coach Edmonston. Woolard has just been lights out so far.
Go ahead. No, I was going to say, and there he goes. I was going to say, you got to be on him, and Kidd was on him pretty good, but Woolard now with 24 in the game.
Yeah, I mean, there's just not much more defense that you can do on that other end than just practically fouling him or knocking him to the ground.
And the thing is that no one's in foul trouble for Prairie Grove, so it's okay to sacrifice someone to just stay in his grill, you know?
Yeah, make him earn his points from here on out.
And I would say this, Stephen, he has to this point. There's Edwards. Bottom! There we go.
That's a big answer. You want to maintain touching distance, especially with Woolard at any moment can come down the floor and jack up a three.
Wow, like that. That time he missed a little bit out of his range. I wouldn't say out of his range. He's just short that time. And now he comes back and steals it. He's going to lay it up, and he's going to lay it in.
I mean, the Woolard kid just does not quit. Doesn't get the three, follows, gets the steal. I mean, this, you talk about, you know, high motor athletes. This is a textbook example of one in black and orange right now for Gravette. It's been quite the show from Woolard. Edmondson going to go to work on the low block. Kicks out. Three on the way.
No good. And Edwards going to knock that one out. 5:09 to go here in the third quarter. Still a 10-point lead for Gravette.
And we'll see what Prairie Grove can answer with. And, of course, so far tonight, 15 for Henderson. He leads all Prairie Grove scorers by a substantial margin. I mean, he has half of the points on the night. It's been a good night for him, but you look the other side of the stat sheet, and it's 26 points for Woolard, who takes another three.
And now he's going to go to the line and shoot three. Here's the thing. He's got over half of their points, but they've got 40.
Yeah.
Oh, Wow, 33. Patton's going to get a foul there, which that helps Prairie Grove. I thought he was about to go to the line and shoot three, so that's good.
Certainly not. I'd agree with that. That's the one Cardinal sin of basketball. Never foul your three-point shooter.
Nice, and good job by Evanston. Good footwork that time by Cole. Cole now with eight in the game. It's 40-32. Prairie Grove needs a couple stops, a couple baskets. Get this thing put in about four.
100%. That time, Edmondson going to work.
Yeah, they're gonna get Cole. He was okay to do that when you extend the arm, and that's what he did right there. He extended it. They're gonna call you for that.
I was just letting Patton know where he was.
Like I said, Patton's got him by about 15 or 20,
yeah,
I believe.
Yeah, I would agree, but you know, it's interesting. We'll see how long Patton stays on the floor, and certainly,
especially with Munoz.
Yeah, I was gonna say Prairie Grove needs to make as much hay as the sun it can shine for. Patton being out on the floor, Edmondson clearly, I think, a better player on the floor whenever he's got the ball and he's guarded by Patton. When Munoz comes in the game, it's a little bit of a different story.
At the line is Isaiah Larson. He's got two free throws. First one's on the way, and he misses it.
Good foul for PG.
Henderson comes in. Yeah, at worst, you got half of what he's going to get. And if he misses this one, you got to come up with that rebound, though. Second one on the way, and he got that one. 41-32.
Man, Cole got run over by a freight train that time by Patton going for the rebound. I was looking at the two of them, and, I mean, Patton, he got in position pretty hard on old Cole Edmondson.
And now they're going to get Patton. I think there's getting a little bit of physical there. And, you know, Cole letting him know that he's there, you know, physically. And now Absher's going to come in. Alex Absher got the ball there. Gives up to Benoit. Benoit's been quiet tonight. Henderson, three-pointer, no good. Rebound into the hands of Patton. And here comes down the floor quickly Woolard.
This is going to be something that I'd like to see as it goes along. Absher and Patton down low.
And there's going to be a push. And Patton is physical in there. He's got another foul, though.
I was talking with Alex's grandfather, Coach Absher of the football team here, and he's proud of his grandson, a physical little basketball player. Had a good junior varsity game a little bit ago, so I'm sure he's a little bit tired, but a little bit, you know, broken into for the night. Got some action, knocked a three-pointer down, hit a couple of free throws.
Well, he's getting pushed inside, no good on the three. He's getting pushed inside pretty good there by Patton.
Yeah, he just goes right back to it like Energizer Bunny.
Yep, and now he gets inside to him, and now he goes up, and they're going to call him for a travel. Should have got a foul there. He got pushed pretty hard, but they're not going to give it to him. It's kind of like in the NBA, if you're a rookie and he's a sophomore, not going to give it to him, you know?
Certainly not. Alex will get those later down the road, I imagine. Just stick with basketball. You'll get those calls.
And Edwards gets that rebound. Jace gives up to Benoit. Take that. Ah! And Edwards, and no good. Rebound goes into the hands of Woolard, and here he comes quickly down the floor.
I was going to say, if Edwards had made that look like Hakeem Olajuwon down there with the dream shake.
Woolard now with 28 in the game. Let's stay with it this time.
That was an interesting possession down the floor, last time down the floor for Prairie Grove. Woolard was actually last player down the court, went to the ground out the far side of in the far corner, and Prairie Grove had a 4-on-5 opportunity, had that mismatch. Benoit, when he pumped to take that shot, Lynn, allowed Woolard to reset himself into the defense of Gravette and lost that opportunity. But Edwards had a good look at it on the low block, put a couple of fancy moves, just couldn't get it to roll in, and Woolard has, you know, had a quiet couple of 30 seconds or whatever and comes down the other end, knocks down. He's like, hey, I'm here, still beating along in this game, 28 points. It's been quite an impressive showing for him.
He's been on fire.
And that's been the thing, you know, here at home, we've noticed on these broadcasts, Lynn, is it seems like Prairie Grove's just had this run of bad luck where one player for the other team will just get hot. I remember Howerton for West Fork earlier on in the non-conference went off, had a 30-point game.
Here comes the Tigers. Henderson is picked up by Betts. Tell you what, that Betts plays tough defense.
He certainly does.
And nice take, no good that time by Henderson. And a rebound. I bet they call Abster for that foul on the floor. He got him pretty good. They may get Edmonston, but I think.
I'm saying white ball.
Oh my gosh. 22.
Yeah, Will Betts. That'll be his first.
Wow.
I'm
surprised he's only got one foul because he's been real aggressive all night. They're gonna call a jump ball and it's gonna go to Gravette. 208. Gravette leads Prairie Grove 43-32.
I imagine in the morning Colebus is going to feel like he got hit by a dump truck as he's just been getting worn out these last couple of possessions by Patton. That time ended up on the hardwood twice in the same possession.
You know, when you look at Woolard, he's not tall. He's not big, but, man, that kid can flat out shoot, and he creates another shot. That one's missed. Good rebound that time by Henry.
Yeah, they're going to get Henry. He went down to a knee and stood up. Yeah, but, no, to your point with Woolard, I mean, he's, you know, I imagine he spent quite a lot of time in his driveway just all over the place, jacking up threes, layups, that sort of thing.
It's amazing how he's able to step back. It's amazing how he's able to step back and get that shot. And he's kind of got that move down. You know, he takes one step forward, steps back, takes a shot. Betts almost threw that up. Three-pointer on the way. Wow. Larson gets a three, and that stretches lead to 14. You got to remember, Prairie Grove was up at 1.8 points.
Yeah, it's that first quarter, Prairie Grove came out firing on all cylinders. You thought, oh, man, where's this been all season? Prairie Grove, you know, getting some momentum, and then Gravette introduced themselves to the party in the second quarter.
Edmonston, nice take, up and in. Cole now with 10 points in the game. 46-34, 1 minute to go, third quarter. Need to close strong here.
An illegal screen. That's going to be on 33 in black.
Wow. Man, Patton, that's got to be four on Patton, I believe. Yeah, and here comes Munoz.
See, and that's the thing that's interesting to me, Lynn, is, you know, Munoz has shown he's kind of the better post player tonight. We'll see what sort of difference this makes on the boards as Munoz has got him a couple of offensive rebounds in that second quarter.
Henderson trying to create something there. And Edmonston go up strong. And now they're going to get Munoz. That's a good move that time by Cole to get that.
Yeah, they keep attacking the posts. Cole using his athleticism and quickness to get after Munoz, has run Patton from the game with a couple of fouls already. If you can't stop Woolard, at least get the other options that have shown to be point scorers for Gravette out of the game and try and figure something out for three in orange and black.
Edmonston misses that first free throw. Would really like to gotten that one, pull this thing down to 10 going into the fourth. Maybe he can get it at least down to 11. Here's Cole, second one on the way, and this one is no good as well. Both of those rattled out. Wow. You got to stay. You got to pick him up at about the jaw of the Tiger.
Yeah, 100%. You might even just think about picking him up off the inbounds. He can accelerate, get to his spot where he wants to go. It's like he's playing chess at the moment for Gravette.
What a play by Gravette. Well, they keyed in on Woolard. He fed number 12, Isaiah Larson, who hit his second three, 49-34. We'll be back for the fourth quarter after this.
Divers LLC is a local family business serving your disposal needs since 2010. We are licensed haulers providing 15-yard dumpsters with prompt and friendly service. Please call us today for a free quote at 479-966-5878. Please like and share us on Facebook. We look forward to serving you soon.
All right, we're back. It's time for the fourth quarter. Tigers down 49-34. So Tigers lost 5 points. They were down by 10 at half. Looked like they were going to be down 10 at the end of the third. Missed two free throws. So it's still 12, and then Gravette bangs down a three to give them a 15-point lead.
Yeah,
played them pretty even for that quarter until the last 10 seconds.
Yeah, and it's, you know, Johnny come lately for Isaiah Larson. He had that one free throw at the beginning of the third quarter, and then
And the way he shot his first free throw, I'm like, I thought he's not a shooter. So I was cool with him taking that three, but he made both of them. Both of his threes, he knocked them down.
He's making the most out of his minutes in this second half. Prairie Grove going to have to find an answer.
We're going to have to get it started quick in the quarter. And I think that's where you got to go. Edmonston shot and no good. Looking for a foul, doesn't get it. And now they're going to get hit Edmonston for the foul. He's mad. He's a little frustrated. That was a little bit of a frustration foul by Cole.
And he's got three on the night. We'll have to watch it the rest of the way.
Larson now. Shot. Where did he come from? Larson now with three straight threes. He pulls the lead up to 18.
And he's got 10 of his own. Oh, 100%. Isaiah Larson, you think, comes into the third quarter, 0 points.
Short that time by Henderson. Here comes Woolard. And now Woolard, this is not good. And he misses it. And there's the big man inside again. And they're going to get Edwards with a foul. I'll tell you what, that Munoz, look, I'm not taking anything away from Patton. Patton's played good, solid night. When Munoz is in there, his aggressiveness on the offensive board has been a huge difference in this game. And you think about it, Prairie Grove had the lead at the end of the first quarter, and he makes a free throw. They had the lead at the end of the first quarter. And after that, he came in the second quarter, and he was cleaning up the boards, and they were getting second and third chances, and that is what really started that. And then, of course, you've got Woolard knocking down every three he takes, so that helps stretch that lead as well. 19-point lead now for Gravette as Munoz makes one of two. Henderson in and out. Edmonston trying hard to get a rebound. Unable to do it. Here comes Woolard. And Woolard going to go drive. He shot. No good. Rebound. There's the big man. There he is cleaning up the glass again. No good. Got another rebound.
Just padding
this
his stats
time,
at this
they
point.
May get him. Yeah. Yeah, they're going to get him for leaning in that time.
I'd agree, but, man, Munoz just come in and cleaned up the offensive board.
And here's my thing here. I mean, you know, of course, with the Prairie Grove announcers, we want Prairie Grove to win every game they play. But, you know, being you know, I'm not objective. We're never objective. But if you're going to do this, you've got to really compliment when the other team does things well. And I have just been impressed with Munoz, been impressed with Willard. And all of a sudden, Larson comes out, and I'm like, where did he come from? There's a three by Henry, no good. Wow, that should have been another foul at time on Munoz, but no call. Henry with the ball, and he shot, floater, no good. There's the big man. Go up, Bolin. No good. Bolin, no, they're going to get him for over the back.
He can't help, he's taller than everybody else on the floor.
I love that kid, though, man. His enthusiasm, his leadership, you know, on the football field, you saw it. He's, you know, all-state center. On the basketball floor, this is probably isn't his best sport, but I will say this about him. His leadership and his infectious personality really helps lift this team.
Yeah, I believe during the Colors Day procession, he's listed as one of the captains for this team. Yeah, and he's going to let – he lets Munoz know a little bit. Yeah, no. You might have been able to do that when Cole was on the floor, but this is my house now. You're going to play by my rules.
Yeah, he's a little bit bigger than – you know, Munoz, big kid. Yeah, he got some brute to him, but like you said, Corbin said, hey, you know, I want to remind you what happened in Gravette earlier in September. Shot on the way, no good on the free throw.
Yeah, of course, that's right. Yeah, played him in football. I was just right before I think we got hooked
up. Yeah, that was my last time of doing the technical aspect of this thing. Corbin comes out. Go ahead.
I was just going to say, seeing Gravette earlier in football season, doing some Green Forest games, they're on a nice trajectory for the football side of things. I know that program in years past had really fallen on some hard times, players leaving, not a lot of turnout, not a lot of wins, but I know Kelby Bohannon, coach up there for the Lions, has kind of got them on the right path, have made it into the postseason the last couple of years, and should be in 2024 a conference game for your Prairie Grove football Tigers.
Assuming it goes, and there's Henry. Willard made the last shot down on the other end. He's now got 30 in the game, and now Henry picks up his first basket. Austin. I'm a little – well, I guess there's, what, 19-point lead.
Mm-hmm.
And a little floater up, no good. And rebound – oh, they're going to get – what? Wow. I'm surprised with that. When Munoz came in pretty hard, I thought they was going to get in for a foul. Munoz strong. He's strong.
He is. But not a receiver, though.
No. If he was on the football field, I imagine he's going to be in the trenches.
Yeah, I'd say that's a pretty safe guess. I'm kind of surprised, you know, and you see at this level a lot of dual sport athletes like Bolin for Prairie Grove, that Rhett Hilger not out on the floor for Gravette, quarterback for them.
Alex misses, and that there's Edmondson now with his fourth foul. I think Cole's a little frustrated because there's been a lot of banging inside, and I think he's actually played pretty well, but he's gotten the short end of the stick on some of these calls.
Yeah, no, I would agree with that as well. And, you know, that's something we talked about. Cole, the more athletic, quicker post player versus what Gravette has put out on the floor, the more physical post player. And I think Munoz and Patton have just worn him down tonight.
And Munoz makes that free throw. He's now 2 of 5 from the line, trying to go to, 50% with this one. Oh, lane violation. So, no free throw attempt there. Gravette leads by 20. Speaking of free throws, so last night my bachelor's degree alma mater had Gonzaga by 10 late in the game, winning it, and then Gonzaga hits a three at the end. There's Henderson for three short. He's going to go to the line. And then just let it get away. You could almost just watch it slip through their fingers last night. It was one of those – you're watching, you're going, you got this. Just, you got it. And you know, let it get away.
I was going to say, on the side, I've been doing some Division II basketball over in the Tulsa area. And
Let me just notate that Henderson makes the first of three free throws. Keep going.
Rogers State University was playing the number 8 team in D2, University of Central Oklahoma. And UCO ended up, I believe, only missing two free throws for the entire night. Went 18 of 18 in the second half as Rogers State was trying to stay in the game late. It's just those free throws, is that last one off the mark for Prairie Grove. Free throws can keep you in or make you lose basketball games very easy on either side of the scale.
Well, I got to tell you, Henderson that time makes 2 of 3, and you're right about free throws. And let's see how much more damage. Oh, there's a three-pointer. No good. Nice rebound that time by Larson. And there's Munoz coming out, and he gives it up. Oh, my gosh.
Just can Woolard, only laugh at
one,
this point.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6 threes in the game. He's got 33 points.
You're running out of space on your paper there.
Yeah, I am. I'm going to have to – at least Duet's not playing. Bottom! Hey, we got something there. Henderson now with 20 in the game himself. He's got almost half of Prairie Grove's points. 59-41. And no good that time. And Kidd almost gets knocked. He does. Got knocked out of bounds by his own player. Mm. You know, and, you know, Henderson tonight with 1, 2, 3, 4 threes himself. But we were talking about that game last night. The Marriott Center where the Cougars play, it seats about 20,000. And like Bud Walton, that thing can get rocking. And I'm sure last night, I've been in that building a few times, and it's a lot of fun. Yeah, but I'll tell you what, Bud Walton on Wednesday night was loud for a bit. It really was loud.
Yeah, you know, when they can fill that place up, there's not a lot of basketball gyms in America, I think, that can compete with. And I know I work with a few Kansas Jayhawk alums, and, you know, they talk about how great and mighty Allen Fieldhouse is, but it doesn't quite get as many bodies in it as what Bud Walton can.
Wow, look at that floater that time by Betts. And now timeout called. He's going to take a full. And my guess is they're going to let the starters come out. 61-41 with 3 minutes. And Betts gets his second basket of the game. 61-41, Tigers probably going to fall to 1-5 in the conference.
My name is Jackson, and my family owns Faithful Auto in Farmington, and we love Jesus. Being upfront and honest are part of our core values. You can come see us for your complete auto care. We offer computer diagnostics, brake work, air conditioning service and repair, front end and oil changes. By the way, our computer system uploads your maintenance records to Carfax, so you can take super good care of your car. Have you been in a fender bender? Let us do your collision repair. We're open Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, so call for an appointment. We're proud to support the Prairie Grove Tigers. Go Tigers!
All right, we're back, 61-41. And I'm going to be surprised. I think, No, they've got most of the guys back in. I thought they were going to maybe bring some substitutes in, but it looks like they're going to keep their starters in a little longer. 20-point lead with 3 minutes to go. And Prairie Grove has got the ball, and Henderson will bring it down.
Yeah, that's an interesting call from Gravette, I would assume. It must just be maybe Woolard's close to some sort of either PR or record or something. You know, at this point, you have 33. I think you can kind of call the dogs off and call it an evening.
I'd like to see, you know, Benoit's had a quiet night. There's Henry. No good. Edmonston gets it up and in. So Cole now with 12 in the game. Prairie Grove takes a 30. We'll stay with it this time. Yeah, you know, we said on the beginning tonight that we knew Henderson might get streaky, and he has. He's got 20 points. We've got Edmonston coming in with 12 more, so there's 32 of the 43. And I'm not – Benoit usually is all over, you know, getting a lot of rebounds, and he's just been a little quiet tonight. I wish in a way, and I know he doesn't match up with him probably from a physical standpoint as far as, like, the smaller, probably quicker Woolard. But I think he would be the guy that would probably give him the most fits. But, he's probably so quick. That's why you got to put a Kidd or a Henderson on him. to kind of keep him at bay.
Certainly not. I agree with that 100%. Benoit, you know, has shown at times throughout the season he really can be the leading defender for Prairie Grove. He's limited a lot of guys throughout the course of the year. But no, I think, yeah, you know, he's just a little bit bigger, and Woolard can, man, he can turn the Jets on to get to his spot, and we've seen that to, you know, 33 points to his name on the evening, and still 2.5 minutes to go. Who knows if he gets any more?
He's got 33 in the game. They get it into Betts. Betts to Larson. Larson's going to get over the timeline, and it looks like to me that the way that Woolard was standing there, 32nd from Gravette, looked like Woolard was wanting the ball. It looked like he's wanting to get that 40. And getting ready to check in for Prairie Grove is Evan Weil and Corbin Bowling going to come back in.
Yeah, it's been some most minutes I think Corbin's had at home this season.
Yeah, and Coach may be doing that. You know, if he's one of the captains on the team, one of the things, it's colors day, colors night, gives him a chance to, you know, to do that. And at this point, I'm not saying a miracle can't happen. It would have to be a real miracle down by 18 with 2:22. But I'm glad to let him see you get Weil and Bolin both in the game.
And while we have a moment, it's something that's always been a curiosity to me is being from Missouri, we don't have Colors Day. We just do a second homecoming during basketball season. So do you know where
it comes from? The same thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I don't know where it comes from. It was new to me when I came to Arkansas. Of course, I came to Arkansas almost 30 years ago, but it was new to me. Now, what Coach Ed has in here is he's got five seniors in there, which is cool.
That certainly is. These are some meaningful moments for all these guys.
They're going to have a little push off there. So, yeah, Corbin is a senior. Kidd's a senior. Henry is a senior. Weil is a senior. And Benoit is also a senior. So, under 2 minutes to go. Tigers trail by 18. Fire up a three, Corbin.
Might as well. What would it hurt?
If you one thing about Gravette, they haven't given up. And, oh, trying to give it up. Henry now with a ball. Weil. Corbin, they want to get Corbin a shot. I think that was a pass. I do think he had no arch on it, so I think it was a pass. But I think Coach Ed's letting the seniors play here on Colors Day and letting them take a shot at it. And here comes across the timeline. That's going to be Woolard, and Woolard's going to dribble it down, probably run this shot clock down to about 5 or 10. And then Prairie Grove may get one or two more possessions.
Yeah, we'll see how this one closes out. Next up will be
Berryville.
Yeah, Berryville. And that is going to be a sneaky good opponent. They did well last season. And they are right on track this year. If you're familiar on the Southern Sports Network with the Green Forest Holiday Tournament coverage we had earlier, two of the players for Berryville that'll be in the gym on Tuesday night. We're all tournament team players, and Jake Wilson and Nate Allen.
35 now. No, we really appreciate our partnership with the Southern Sports Network. And now another steal. That's going to do it. And the final score looks like it's going to be Gravette 63, Prairie Grove 43. Willard's going to end up with 35 tonight, over half of the points for Gravette. Henderson leads the Prairie Grove scores with 20. Edmonston with 12. Kidd with 4. And who else has got on the board? Edwards had 5. And Austin Henry with 2. That's going to do it. We're going to take a break. And we'll be back for the girls' game in about, let's say about 10 minutes.
of Auto and Farm Supply is an independently owned and operated CarQuest auto parts store, a family-owned mom-and-pop business that's been servicing this community since 1983. They can source auto parts from CarQuest and Advanced Auto Warehouses, receiving shipments 5 nights a week. For all your auto parts needs, or if you just want to come down and drink some coffee with the old guys, come see Larry and Karen and the dog Rosie at 119 East Buchanan Street, historic downtown Prairie Grove.
Dumpster Divers LLC is a local family business serving your disposal needs since 2010. We are licensed haulers providing 15-yard dumpsters with prompt and friendly service. Please call us today for a free quote at 479-966-5878. Please like and share us on Facebook. We look forward to serving you soon.
Hi, my name is Jackson, and my family owns Faithful Auto in Farmington, and we love Jesus. Being upfront and honest are part of our core value. You can come see us for your complete auto care. We offer computer diagnostics, brake work, air conditioning service and repair, front end and oil changes. By the way, our computer system uploads your maintenance records to Carfax, so you can take super good care of your car. Have you been in a fender bender? Let us do your collision repair. We're open Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, so call for an appointment. We're proud to support the Prairie Grove Tigers. Go Tigers!
Harden Furniture is conveniently located on Highway 62 between Prairie Grove and Farmington. Terry Harden carries staple brands such as Mayo, Best Chair, Ashley, Rustonic, and Vaughn Bassett. Terry has over 20 years of experience in the furniture business, and he works hard to keep a well-stocked inventory, but has many more options available through custom orders. So come by and see Terry Harden at Harden's Furniture for all your furniture needs. He'll treat you right.
Statistics show out of 3 million people in Arkansas, 55% do not attend church on a weekly basis. We value the Word of God in our services. We strive to present it in a practical and engaging way. This is a place where you can belong even before you believe. We will accept you as you are, but we will give you the practical steps to encourage and develop you on your pathway to Christ. We are here for you every step of the way. We'll save a seat for you.
Zing Broadband is a proud sponsor of area schools and is excited to offer incredible fast internet speeds. Our students can focus on what really matters, knowing that Zing Broadband can keep up with them. We recognize the hard work and dedication of our students and athletes, and we've built a network to deliver their demand. Zing Broadband proudly serves our local communities and supports all their endeavors.
Kimball Mechanical Systems specializes in installing plumbing, HVAC, and electrical systems in mid to large housing projects, including subdivisions, apartment complexes, and military housing. Kimball wants to partner with more people who want to earn a good living in the skilled trades. Kimball is the largest mechanical contractor in Arkansas with 8 other locations nationwide. Kimball is proud to have won Arkansas's Best Places to Work 5 years in a row. They provide excellent benefits and an amazing family-oriented culture. For great job opportunities, check out kmsjobs.com.
Zing Broadband is a proud sponsor of area schools and is excited to offer incredible fast internet speeds. Our students can focus on what really matters, knowing that Zing Broadband can keep up with them. We recognize the hard work and dedication of our students and athletes, and we've built a network to deliver their demand. Zing Broadband proudly serves our local communities and supports all their endeavors.
Show out of 3 million people in Arkansas, 55% do not attend church on a weekly basis. We value the Word of God in our services. We strive to present it in a practical and engaging way. This is a place where you can belong even before you believe. We will accept you as you are, but we will give you the practical steps to encourage and develop you on your pathway to Christ. We are here for you every step of the way. We'll save a seat.
Kimball Mechanical Systems specializes in installing plumbing, HVAC, and electrical systems in mid to large housing projects, including subdivisions, apartment complexes, and military housing. Kimball wants to partner with more people who want to earn a good living in the skilled trades. Kimball is the largest mechanical contractor in Arkansas with 8 other locations nationwide. Kimball is proud to have won Arkansas's Best Places to Work 5 years in a row. They provide excellent benefits and an amazing family-oriented culture. For great job opportunities, check out kmsjobs.com.
Can I have your attention, please, to announce tonight's starting lineups? First, from the visiting Gravette Lady Lions. Number 1, the Lacey Vishon. Number 3, Brooke Handel. Number 10, Alexa Parker. Number 22, Brynn Brahman. Number 40, Keely Elsie. Lady Lions are coached by Will Pittman. And for your Prairie Grove Lady Tigers, number 1, Cameron Cash.
Ava Nall. Number 22, Lexi Henry. Number 32, Ella Falk. And number 35, Kenley Elder. Many Tigers are coached by Scott Green.
All right, we're back for the girls' game and hopefully for a little bit better fortunes this time than we had last game in the boys' game. Steven, as we get ready to start here, PG Tigers Online brought to you by Southern Sports Network, ready for the tip-off of this second game. Tip is going to go. And look at Deshaun. Deshaun. Oh, I know, like I said, I know her dad. He's got to be over there somewhere. I gotta hunt him down. There we go. And here comes Gravette down the floor quickly. That's 40 with the ball. That is Elsie. Gets into Washawn. Washawn up, no good. Rebound. Washawn back out, kicks it. Three-pointer on the way, no good. Boy, Gravette is just dominating the boards. That was a loud sound. I hope everybody's okay.
Yeah, it looks like everybody gonna get up.
Wow, I'm telling you what. Let's see, Romine?
I think it's Romine.
Romine?
I believe there was a player on the football team a couple years ago, grabbed it. Last name was Romine, so I would assume Romine. That's probably related.
Well, she went down hard, and I guess they're just calling a player down. Well, Sean with the ball. Romine, shot, no good. Foul's going to be on Falk, I believe. No.
They're going to get Nall.
No, it's Nall. They're going to get Nall with that foul.
It's been a slow start to the game. We've gone halfway through the
Prairie Grove hadn't even got a shot yet.
Yeah, it's all been on this end of the floor.
And well, I'll tell you, not only have they not got a shot yet, they haven't even gotten
possession.
Out of that possession yet. They've had three or four. Second shot, and the second one's on the way and good from Oman. And they're bringing the pressure right off the bat. Here's Henry, gets it to Cash. Cash gets over the timeline, and Cash is being aggressive. She's going to pull it out now. Cross-court pass to Nall. Boy, Gravette is being very tight on the defense. And there's Falk comes in strong, gets that loose ball. Kicks it out, Cash for three, no good, rebound goes to Henry, and now we're going to get our second chance.
Yeah, I think maybe tonight might be a story of second chance opportunities for either side. Not able to get in good position to get a defensive board. Fresh 35,
no.
But ooh.
Ball thrown away there, a turnover. And Gravette will take possession. 1-0, about a buck and a half already gone through the first quarter.
You don't see that happen too often. You don't see that score 1-0 this much into a ball game.
And they're going to call. Oh, they're going to call Falk. And Ella's a little surprised by that, I believe. That's her second foul. In the building, I see on the across the way, former Prairie Grove coach Kevin Froud. He's wearing green with his Greenland, though. I see that. He's a decked out in the green.
Yeah, big week for Greenland. They are going to be one of the host sites for the state baseball tournament.
Yeah, I saw that too.
Of course, in 4A, Farmington's bid was unsuccessful. It's going to be Blytheville, I believe.
Yeah, Blytheville, of all places. Well, congratulations to Blytheville.
Yeah.
It's just a long trip for us.
Certainly is. That's actually not too far down the road from my hometown, so I might see mom and dad when I go home.
Let's hope the Tigers, boys or girls, can make it there.
I would 100% agree there.
And now Ella gets it over the timeline. And, boy, Henry was begging for the ball over there. And she was up, and there's Nall over to Cash to Henry. Henry for three. No good. Going to be a push that time, I believe, on Elsie.
And Nall hits the floor again. No, pardon me, Falk hits the floor again. Yeah, interesting looking at the state tournament hosts for basketball. Only one school or one town in Northwest Arkansas of the six are getting to host, and that's Rogers up the road on I-49.
Got to get it in. Oh, boy, that was close.
It certainly was. Cash thought, and then she thought again. Normally you don't get away with that second thought.
Bella Barnes checked into the game for Prairie Grove. Nall with the ball. Henry for three off the back of the rim. Ball rebound goes to Washawn, and she's going to give it up. And here comes down the floor again is Romine. Parker, no good. Rebound. I'll tell you what, I don't know if Gravette is going to shoot the ball well tonight or not, but they are getting some rebounds.
Certainly, and if you give them second chance opportunities or give them
eventually it's going to happen, yeah. Cash, bottom! There we go. Finally at the 5:13 mark, Prairie Grove gets on the board. 3-1.
Man, that thing had such arc on it, brought rain down with it.
And quickly down the floor. Elsie gets that basket, and it's fourth. It's all tied up at three. Elsie with two there. And man, you better get it across. It's, let's see, they've got 3 seconds left. 2 seconds. Whoa. Yep, that's 10 seconds. Mm-hmm. I'm watching the shot clock.
It's
easy
to do that math.
That's the one thing now is that it's easy to do that math, and it was just a little bit of hesitation. Good job that time by the Gravette Lady Lions to get the turnover on the 10 seconds. Coach Reed will not be happy with that. Coach Reed looking sharp tonight with a nice, crisp white shirt and a tie.
Freshly pressed.
There it is. They're getting the loose ball. Right now, Gravette is the loose balls, the rebounds, everything going their way. Shot, no good. Nice. Wow. Did you see?
Yeah, it just basically cleared her out.
Well, Sean just said, hey, I know you're boxing me out, but I'm just going to go ahead and
pull the chair out from underneath you.
Yeah, that's what happened. Three-pointer on the way. This one, no good. And she did it again. And Prairie Grove, I got to tell you, I'm impressed with this with the Gravette Lady Lions. The loose balls, rebounds, they've been really getting them tonight. And Prairie Grove's got to step it up a little bit, start making some of those go our way.
Certainly so.
And Bella Barnes, luckily, now Henry with it. She goes up strong, up, and just off the rim. Still tied up at three halfway through the first quarter. Ooh, wow.
Close to the baseline.
Elsie is close to the baseline.
Looked like a discus thrower, bringing that foot over the toe board, getting it back in the ring.
3:30 to go here in the first quarter. All tied up at three. Stolen by Henry. And now she's going to get fouled by Romine. 3:30 to go. Slow start for both. I'd say a fast start for loose balls, rebounds for Gravette. Slow start for both teams scoring-wise.
Certainly has been. Gravette's had the opportunities, haven't been able to finish them. And Prairie Grove fans should take solace in that, but bad that, pass out of bounds.
And you kind of got it. You know, when something like that happens, this is something I feel. And I thought in the Prairie Grove in the boys' game is when, like, they haven't scored all this, that's a good sign. It's like, look, now you just need to stop that. You start scoring. Shot, no good. Rebound goes to Elder. And in the boys' game, it was like, okay, you know, you need to score while Munoz is out. Didn't happen. Henry drives, lays it up, off the no good, and Bella Barnes, surprised she didn't get a foul over the back, but that's okay. 3 minutes. 3 minutes and 3-3.
Defensive struggle so far for sure.
And it's stolen by Henry. Nice job by Henry. She drives, lays it up, and in. Lexi Henry does a nice job. Great steal that time. Good timing. And there's Washawn's shot up and in. So both times that Prairie Grove's gotten a basket, Washawn quickly, both times they got in the basket, they quickly got down and got a, and made up for it. Get it across. Wow, we only made that by 1 second. Oh, she double dribbled. I thought she was going to get away with it for just a second.
Yeah, it was a bit of a delayed whistle. But yeah, and this is something we've seen earlier in the season for the women's Prairie Grove Tiger basketball team. They have a bit of trouble with that full court press and being able to navigate around it. West Fork comes to mind. That was how they were able to kind of stay in that ballgame late. They turned the switch on defensively. But we'll see if the girls can make an adjustment in this first quarter.
No good on the three-pointer. Someone's going to get, I think, a foul push underneath. It's 20. That is in the game is Gracie Moffitt. And Moffitt picks up a foul. It's the third team foul on Gravette. Three, Prairie Grove's got three. Nobody, let's see. Yeah, we do have two. Ella Falk has two fouls. Well, you better get it across. Nope, there they go again. I'll tell you, with that shot clock, it's easy to look up. You don't have to do this whole count thing. Which I've seen a lot of delayed counting over the years.
Yeah, because it's much more of a art back in the day before the shot clock. Now it's definitely an exact science.
You just look up there and say, hey, look, it's 25 seconds. End of the game, checking in, the freshman, Hope Kidd. One thing I loved about Kidd playing with Sean, shot, no good, going to be fouled. One thing I like about Kidd, she wasn't afraid. Being a freshman, her first action last time we played, she came right in and started shooting the ball.
Yeah, and it couldn't have come against a harder opponent in the Farmington girls basketball team a week or so ago on Tuesday.
Well, Sean makes the first free throw, second one on the way, and it's good. So, 7-5, Gravette leads the Lady Tigers. Here comes Cash. There's going to be a foul. That's the second foul already on Moffitt. She's got two. The team's got four. Both teams have four fouls. So I imagine in the second quarter, we're probably going to see some one-on-ones.
Yeah, we're right on pace for it. Might help us get some points on the board either way.
And there's a fifth foul. I think that's going to be on three. That's going to be on Handel. Brooke Handel with that foul. Now five team fouls for Gravette. Probably was a good foul because I think Prairie Grove is about to get a basket there. 7-5. Gravette leads Prairie Grove. Bella Barnes, shot. No good. Rebound. Nice. Wow. That was Kidd inside. Kidd is probably 5-1, 5-2 maybe.
Hey, giving up a couple of inches down there in the painted area.
Yeah, they're going to get Kidd for the foul. Now five team fouls on Prairie Grove. 7-5.
Yeah, we've had a touchdown and an extra point. Safety and a field goal.
Speaking of football.
Yes.
I saw one team play it in the national championship game. I did not see another team play it.
I now know why it's called the Little 12.
And now that is a nice take that time to remind. 9-5, Gravette leads. Elder, she's trapped, and now it's Henry. Wide open is Kidd. Kidd drive, shot on the way up and good. Hope Kidd. Freshman comes in, knocks it down, 9-7. I think Prairie Grove just, they've got to overcome a little bit of some mistakes, but Barnes lucky she didn't get a call for a foul there. Wow, big
miss. Definitely stuck a hand in.
Now take one shot. Well, here comes Henry quickly down the floor. And she's going to get an easy basket out of it. Up and in. And now Lexi Henry with four in the game. 9-all. And looks like Gravette will take the final shot. Down to 10 seconds to go. First quarter. With Sean, gives it back. No good. Rebound. Shot. One quarter in the books. Prairie Grove 9. Gravette 9. Back after this.
of Auto and Farm Supply is an independently owned and operated CarQuest Auto Parts store, a family-owned mom-and-pop business that's been servicing this community since 1983. They can source auto parts from CarQuest and Advanced Auto Warehouses, receiving shipments 5 nights a week. For all your auto parts needs, or if you just want to come down and drink some coffee with the old guys, come see Larry and Karen and the dog Rosie at 119 East Buchanan Street, historic downtown Prairie Grove.
All right, we're back, getting ready for the second quarter. Steven, what a first quarter. Really not a lot of great shooting. We saw a lot of, the only three-pointer was from Cash. Everything else has most been putbacks, rebounds, second chances, loose balls picked up, turnovers. As bad as – I would say, Prairie Grove didn't play as well as they could have, and to be tied, they probably should be happy after that first quarter.
Yeah, no, I would agree. You know, both sides really have struggled to put the ball through the hoop. Gravette's had well more opportunities than Prairie Grove down on their end of the floor, getting offensive boards, second chance opportunities, just can't get them to fall. And I think Prairie Grove, if you're in this situation, you're tied at 9, fairly thankful that you go into the second quarter with an opportunity to take the lead on the first possession.
And here's Cash. She's got the ball. Kid. No, back out to Cash. And Elder, no good. I like that shot there by Elder. Going to be knocked away by Kid. I like that shot. Elder, that's probably about, what, about a six-footer, seven-footer there. Just didn't fall for her.
Yeah, and it was an open look. You know, you keep taking that shot. That one will eventually go down. That's a high percentage look. And you have some reinforcements there to potentially get an offensive board. Can't do that, though, on the other end.
I got it. What you got to give with Sean credit there. She went up strong, and Elder really had no choice but to foul her or to give her an easy basket. And I think that was a good move that time to do that. Here comes. And Sean misses that free throw.
Yeah, so far, so good. A good foul for Elder, at least limited to half of the points you could have got down on this end of the floor.
Well, Sean, she misses both. So now she's 2 of 4 from the line, and that ended up being a pretty good foul. But now there's 6 fouls on Prairie Grove. There's Cash. Gives it back inside to Kid. Kid working up, partially blocked. And nice job by the freshman to keep the ball alive.
Yeah, you know, we said it against Farmington. She's not afraid as a freshman to get in there and get her hands dirty.
And Henry's going to get fouled. I didn't see who that foul. It's going to be on with Sean. And Henry can go to the line and get Lady Tigers the lead back. And the first one is short as Henry misses. 0 for 1 now.
It was an awfully quick fire from Henry once she received the ball in from the official.
Yeah, it didn't take her long to fire that up. This time she takes a little more time. Second one's on the way, and it rolls out. So both her and Sean both go 0 for 2 from the line. We're still tied at 9. Parker gives it up. And shot on the way up and in by Elsie.
That was a nifty little up and under move from Elsie.
It really was a nice move. But, boy, Prairie Grove's getting in trouble again on this. There, Henry. Yeah, I like that. I like when Henry goes one-on-one. Lexi Henry now ties game back 11. When you got Henry one-on-one, I like our chances.
Yeah, that's where she likes to live, I think, as a scoring player. For Prairie Grove, that's kind of what her game is predicated around, is taking her defender one-on-one,
great,
attacking the hole.
I don't want to miss this. That was great defense that time by Elder. Elder was able to stand there, hold her hands up, alter the shot, and the Lady Tigers come away with the defensive stands.
And Hope Kidd has it now, but she was calling for it on the low block. She was wide open, had an easy basket opportunity.
Oh, no! That was a late whistle.
That certainly was. Yeah, much to the ire of the home faithful, I have to say, I agree with him, that thing.
Wow, that was, you know, if you're going to call that, I here's what I think. I think if she'd have made it, I don't think he'd have called it. I don't think he's going to give her the and one, but, and she makes the first one. is Bryn Romine. And she's 2 of 3 from the line, make it 2 of 4 from the line.
Yeah, both teams, indicative of the score on the scoreboard being a 12-11 ball game, are struggling at the charity line.
Kid, not afraid, up, and hey! I like the freshman there. She goes up, she's got 4 in the game, gives Prairie Grove the lead for the first time since it was 3-1, now 13-12.
I hope Kid's coming out strong as a freshman. Not afraid, gets the board the other end, Lynn.
I'll tell you what, we get to watch her, Steven, for 3 more years. This is going to be a lot of fun.
And she's only going to get better.
Oh, let's do that one away. But
I think that one we'll take blame on that one, yeah, commentator curse.
Yeah, that was. Gravette takes a timeout. Let's take it with them. 5:22 to go in first half. Tigers up by 1. All right, we're back. 5:22 to go here in the first half. Prairie Grove Lady Tigers leading the Gravette Lady Lions 13-12. Steven, neither one of these teams are going to get accused of lighting up the scoreboard tonight right now.
Yeah, it's been slow going either side, and quite frankly, I think that might, as the game wears on, kind of favor Prairie Grove. They like to get a basket down in the painted area, down in the low block, try and get a drive from Lexi Henry, potentially. Those are the sort of places where they like to live.
And I think, just from what I've seen, now you never know because you may not be seeing the best from Gravette Lady Lions. There's a 3-pointer on the way. And I was just about to make a comment. I hadn't seen a shooter yet. And then all of a sudden, Handel hits the 3, gives them a 2-point lead. So far, I know Cash, I know Henry, and I believe Kidd and Nall can all get hot. But where I'm seeing Gravette get most of their points are on rebounds, putbacks, ball inside. And Coach Pittman, he's wanting that ball for himself. I'm not so sure. I don't disagree with him.
It certainly was a bang-bang play. He's arguing that Henry's foot was out of bounds when the ball hit her hands off a Gravette line, but it's going to stay to the team in white.
I did thought it went off her leg. But we'll take it. Nall, cross-court pass to Henry. Henry back to Nall, back to Cash. And there's Kidd. Kidd wants it. Nall for 3. In and out, no good. Elder battling for rebound. I think she's going to get fouled by Washawn. That might be a 1-1.
It will be, yeah. Going to put Tigers in the bonus, I believe.
And that's Washawn. That's going to be her second foul. 1-1.
Oh, no, it's going to be on the floor.
I know, still 1-1.
It should be, yeah. Now here comes the – we were a little bit ahead of the officials, I believe.
That's usual. That's
yeah,
normal.
Yeah, exactly. You know, we know what we're doing up here.
Yeah, it's normal for us to be ahead of them. I know we don't get watched by everybody, but if there's an official, I'm like, man, that look, cocky guys out in Prairie Grove.
That was always the thing in Green Forest this last year, whenever the officials would come up to give their card to the PA guys, they'd always be like, hey – We were never here if there was a bad call. You don't know our names.
Kinley Elder, Colors Day Queen. Queen Elder.
That's Queen, a good ring to it.
Queen Elder knocks the first one down, and Queen Elder knocks the second one down. So Prairie Grove now 2 of 4 from the line. We're tied up at 15 as the Queen gets on the board. And, oh, no, 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 no. Nice take that time by number 22, Bryn Romine.
Yeah, they're going to get Nall on the foul.
Romine now with 6 in the game. She's going for the old-fashioned 3 here. And she rattles it in. She is now 3 of 5 from the line. Prairie Grove, this is where they've struggled. It's a little bit getting the ball past. Does it pretty easily that time. Cross-court pass. Whoa, almost got away from her. And there's Henry. A long three, short. Little too far that time, I think, for Henry.
Yeah, needed about a step closer to the basket, and that thing would have found the bottom of the nylon.
Three-pointer, and there's Elder. I like the way Elder boxed out that time on Wichon. And Cash has it and gets it over the timeline.
Ooh. Might have got away with double dribble.
I think she may have, too. It looked like it went off her, you know, just kind of held it on her leg there for a minute. Oh, kid. Boy, that was a nice look. And now here comes Henry, kicks it out. Cash for three. Bottom! And Cash is in. 18 all.
Is that a big basket? Just maintaining pace with what Gravette's doing on the other end of the floor at the moment.
A little bit more scoring. It was 9-9 at the end of the first. We've already doubled that here in the second quarter. About 3 minutes, a little over 3 minutes to go here. So both teams. Now she did a nice job of maintaining
that. They kept the dribble, yeah.
Cash. You can't give them that many turns. That's what you can't do. You cannot give them three chances.
Certainly, it looked like on the second chance rebound, it was a couple of Tigers got in the way of each other, and eventually it falls into the safe hand to grab it, and that's
gonna be a
fortuitous foul call.
Yeah, it is, and that's going to be on Mormon. So I believe that'll be Kidd going to the line to shoot a 1-1. 18 fouls on each. And the first one on the way. It is no good, and Henry gets that rebound. Elder drives. Should have been foul. And Queen Elder gets another basket. It's now 21-20, 2.5 minutes to go here in the first half, and that one goes out. Boy, we got to get those rebounds. We're giving them too many chances.
They certainly are. And the important thing is you get the board. It doesn't allow Grav to set up that full court press that Prairie Grove's had trouble with a couple times in this first half.
And now it's going to be an easy basket this time for the Lady Lions. And up and in, 23-21. Handel gets another basket. And Nall gets it over, 23-20. Henry with the ball. That should be a foul. So Cash go to line, shoot a 1-1, 23-20, 1:53 to go.
Yeah, it seems like Gravette has moved into the half-court defense. They're looking for that trap in the middle of the floor. The cognizant of what Prairie Grove's been able to do is forced it to the wings, setting something up on a long cross-court pass in the middle of the floor to poke it away and go out the other end.
So Kidd's going to come out of the game. Coming into it is Autumn Spatz with 1:53. Cash puts it in. Cash now with 7 in the game. 23-21, 1:53 to go. Lexi Henry's going to come back. And the second one on the way. Cash knocks it down. Cash now with 8, 23-22. Lady Tigers need to stop here. Like to see him go in with the lead. Well, it was Henry almost got to it.
Yeah, if her hand was maybe an inch or so longer, she'd be running out the other way for another basket.
Nice shot that time by Alexa Parker. It's her first basket of the game.
Didn't come easy either.
I like this setup, and here is Cash for three, short. And Gravette, 25-22, 1:17, going to get the ball. We may have moved that one a little too quick. Didn't quite get a good – that was a good look. She just a little bit short on it.
Yeah, didn't maybe follow all the way through, get the gooseneck all the way up.
Gravette takes a timeout. Let's take it with them. Lady Lions up by 3.
Divers LLC is a local family business serving your disposal needs since 2010. We are licensed haulers providing 15-yard dumpsters with prompt and friendly service. Please call us today for a free quote at 479-966-5878. Please like and share us on Facebook. We look forward to serving you soon.
All right, we're back with a minute and 10 to go. Lady Tigers are down by 3. A little more scoring here, as I mentioned. That was close to up and down. Thought she pulled her foot there. Three-pointer, no good, and the rebound goes to the Lady Lions. Somebody get that rebound. Spats does. Wow, that's a nice hustle by the Lady Lions. Luckily, the Tigers are able to get that, and now looks like Coach Reed took out Henry not to let her get that third foul. It's probably a good move. Kick out. Somebody's got to get. There's a three short. Rebound. Can Spats. Oh, so 23 grab it. So Spats go line for 1-1 with 29. Actually, it'd be a two-shot foul because they're in a double bonus. Yeah.
That's interesting. I kind of figured Spats was going to be the one getting fouled.
I did too.
It looked like she was pulling the chair out from underneath Ella Mormon, but.
And misses that free throw.
Officials thought otherwise.
So Prairie Grove is 4 of 7 from the line. And there's some players coming in and out. And the Lady Tigers trying to get out of this first half. And misses both free throws. And they're fighting for it. And the Lady Lions are going to have it. And they'll take the last shot. Now, Prairie Grove needs a defensive stop here. You don't want to go down 5.
Yeah, keep it a one-possession game.
Yeah, right now it's close. You haven't played your best basketball. You only go down 3 at half. That's a good half considering, you know, that you've struggled a little bit scoring. Wish Sean's going to get a nice, easy take. Oh, she misses it. Come on, Spats. Spats. Well, that's going to do it. One half of play. Lady Tigers trail the Lady Lions 25-22. Scoring for the leading score for the Lady Lions is Bryn Romine. The scoring for Prairie Grove, Cash with 8, Hope Kidd with 4, Lexi Henry with 6, and Kinley Elder, Queen Elder, with 4. We'll be back for the second half in about 10 minutes.
Kimball Mechanical Systems specializes in installing plumbing, HVAC, and electrical systems in mid to large housing projects, including subdivisions, apartment complexes, and military housing. Kimball wants to partner with more people who want to earn a good living in the skilled trades. Kimball is the largest mechanical contractor in Arkansas with 8 other locations nationwide. Kimball is proud to have won Arkansas's Best Places to Work 5 years in a row. They provide excellent benefits and an amazing family-oriented culture. For great job opportunities, check out kmsjobs.com.
Auto and Farm Supply is an independently owned and operated CarQuest auto parts store, a family-owned mom-and-pop business that's been servicing this community since 1983. They can source auto parts from CarQuest and Advanced Auto Warehouses, receiving shipments 5 nights a week. For all your auto parts needs, or if you just want to come down and drink some coffee with the old guys, come see Larry and Karen and the dog Rosie at 119 East Buchanan Street, historic downtown Prairie Grove.
Dumpster Divers LLC is a local family business serving your disposal needs since 2010. We are licensed haulers providing 15-yard dumpsters with prompt and friendly service. Please call us today for a free quote at 479-966-5878. Please like and share us on Facebook. We look forward to serving you soon.
Hi, my name is Jackson, and my family owns Faithful Auto in Farmington, and we love Jesus. Being upfront and honest are part of our core values. You can come see us for your complete auto care. We offer computer diagnostics, brake work, air conditioning service and repair, front end and oil changes. By the way, our computer system uploads your maintenance records to Carfax, so you can take super good care of your car. Have you been in a fender bender? Let us do your collision repair. We're open Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, so call for an appointment. We're proud to support the Prairie Grove Tigers. Go Tigers!
Harton Furniture is conveniently located on Highway 62 between Prairie Grove and Farmington. Terry Harton carries staple brands such as Mayo, Best Chair, Ashley, Rustonic, and Vaughn Bassett. Terry has over 20 years of experience in the furniture business, and he works hard to keep a well-stocked inventory, but has many more options available through custom orders. So come by and see Terry Harton at Harton's Furniture for all your furniture needs. He'll treat you right.
Statistics show out of 3 million people in Arkansas, 55% do not attend church on a weekly basis. We value the Word of God in our services. We strive to present it in a practical and engaging way. This is a place where you can belong even before you believe. We will accept you as you are, but we will give you the practical steps to encourage and develop you on your pathway to Christ. We are here for you every step of the way. We'll save a seat for you.
Zing Broadband is a proud sponsor of area schools and is excited to offer incredible fast internet speeds. Our students can focus on what really matters, knowing that Zing Broadband can keep up with them. We recognize the hard work and dedication of our students and athletes, and we've built a network to deliver their demand. Zing Broadband proudly serves our local communities and supports all their endeavors.
Kimball Mechanical Systems specializes in installing plumbing, HVAC, and electrical systems in mid to large housing projects, including subdivisions, apartment complexes, and military housing. Kimball wants to partner with more people who want to earn a good living in the skilled trades. Kimball is the largest mechanical contractor in Arkansas with 8 other locations nationwide. Kimball is proud to have won Arkansas's Best Places to Work 5 years in a row. They provide excellent benefits and an amazing family-oriented culture. For great job opportunities, check out kmsjobs.com.
Well, as we get back underway for the second half of action, Little Prairie Grove Lady Tigers trail by five right out of the break. Gravette comes firing. It's Romine puts it up and in. Loose ball. Gravette will, for the moment, have it. Possession arrow will favor Prairie Grove on that alternating possession. And PG will reset it midcourt. Into Henry, who immediately turns it over, intended for Cash. Still not settled. Finally out of there for Gravette is Elsie. Up and off the glass, no good. Henry rebound and run out the other way. First chance this end of the floor, really, for Prairie Grove. It's an air ball, but the second chance can't go either. It's just been a tough start to this penultimate quarter. Played 45 seconds, and it's only been one basket. Another turnover. Cash gets a hand to it. She's going to run the offense the other way. Has Henry behind her. Cash up and fouled. She'll go to the line to shoot a couple of free throws. Brooke Handel, the one who committing the foul for Gravette. That's her second of the day. Cash has eight. Highest scorer for Prairie Grove. And her first one will rattle in. Brings it back within 4 points at the 7:06 minute mark. We wait the second. And the second true as well. It's back to one possession ball game, 27-24. Gravette in the lead. The Gravette basketball across the timeline. But another turnover. Elder out of there finds Cash. And Prairie Grove going to try and string together a couple of opportunities this end of the floor. Finally settled, back to Cash. Prairie Grove going to just work it around. Lexi Henry out of there with it somehow. Cash will have it on the far wing, going to drive. And empty possession that time down the floor is with Sean. Gets the board for Gravette, run it out the other way. Three up, three off the mark. Lexi Henry, easy board for her, no one around to challenge. Cameron Cash will push the tempo. Going to get it back on the wing. She's going to take a three. It off the mark. Rebound underneath the goal. Queen Elder herself able to find the board. She's going to get fouled. Get a couple of opportunities at the charity stripe. And Gravette's committed two early fouls in this second half. We saw both teams running up the fouls in the first half of action. First free throw up and true. Brings it to a two-point advantage for the Lady Lions. Committing the foul that time was Ella Mormon. She has two tonight. Second one off the mark. It's 27-25. Gravette ahead. And Gravette going to push the tempo. They scored the first basket of the second half and have not done anything since. Three up on the way. That one bottom of the net. And true for Brooke Handel. She's got eight for the Lions. Prairie Grove came in tonight 2-3 in conference. Gravette 3-2. So a win for Prairie Grove would put them equal with what the Lions have done so far this season. Move them up the order in the 4A1. Henry the drive fires from about 6 feet. Finds back iron and off the mark for her. And, yeah, possibly a win tonight, depending upon the result in the Huntsville game. Just run out the other end and another empty trip for Gravette. But the result in the Huntsville game could potentially move Prairie Grove into third place on the tiebreaker on the head-to-head with Gravette as Huntsville's 3-2. Coach Reed going to take a timeout. We'll take a quick one with them. More after this.
Kimball Mechanical Systems specializes in installing plumbing, HVAC, and electrical systems in mid to large housing projects, including subdivisions, apartment complexes, and military housing. Kimball wants to partner with more people who want to earn a good living in the skilled trades. Kimball is the largest mechanical contractor in Arkansas with 8 other locations nationwide. Kimball is proud to have won Arkansas's Best Places to Work 5 years in a row. They provide excellent benefits and an amazing family-oriented culture. For great job opportunities, check out kmsjobs.com.
Welcome back to Tigers Gym. as we wait to get back underway in this third quarter. Earlier tonight, the Prairie Grove boys were defeated by the Gravette Lion boys. Up next for both Prairie Grove basketball teams will be a Tuesday night home contest against the Berryville Bobcats. So be in here. They're the hosts of the conference tournament in February. As we get back underway, 5 points the lead for Gravette. It's been just about that since halftime, and well, they're going to get David Nall with a foul. About 18 feet away from the basket. That's going to be a third foul on Nall. Yet to score tonight, and the first foul of the second half for your Prairie Grove Tigers. Three up on the way. Deep three. That one missed badly that time by Mormon. Run out the other way. Cash going to push the tempo. Has Elder and Nall flanking. It'll be Henry to run the offense. It's Prairie Grove just trying to set something up, trying to inch back into this ball game. Nall going to find cross court up and in for Ella Falk. 30-27. As we approach halfway in the third. Oh, and that one just an easy interception thrown right to Ella Falk. As a three here could tie the ball game. Prairie Grove going to have to get it across the timeline. Cash picks up her dribble. Pushed ahead. It's going to be Falk back to Lexi Henry. Oh, whose defender goes to the ground. Nice moves from Lexi. She's going to drive to the hole. Has her shot rejected or partially blocked anyway. Grab it, run out the other way. And Henry atones for her sins on the one end, throws it ahead. Outlet pass barely kept in play by Ava Nall. And Cameron Cash will reset. Henry for three. Oh, that went off the mark just barely. Rebounded by Gravette, by Moffitt. And we got 3:30 to go in the third quarter. Still 3 points the difference between the Lions and Tigers. Three up on the way. That one, an air ball off the mark.
Checking back in for
that time for Gravette. Alexa Parker missing wide. Shiloh and Huntsville are squaring off tonight. Shiloh yet to win a conference game on the girls' side of things, so might be a favorable matchup for Huntsville. But here it is a three-point game. Your Prairie Grove Tiger girls trail by three. 27 their score, but a foul is going to be an opportunity for a couple of free throws. This time for the freshman, Hope Kidd. Hope has 4 points tonight. Going to be the third team foul for Gravette. First free throw up. That one just off the mark for Hope. One more on the way. Could bring this within a regular old field goal and does. As Hope Kidd, give her five on the evening. 28 the score now for Prairie Grove. 30-28. Prairie Grove trails. As the Tigers have maintained touching distance in this third quarter, trying to nose back into the ballgame. And an active hand from Kinley Elder going to force an inbounds play with 15 seconds on the shot clock for the Gravette Lions. To inbound going to be Bryn Romine. She'll set the action. Gets it in easily to Washawn. She's going to hoist a shot and get fouled. Late whistle on the shot, but going to be a couple of free throws nonetheless. They're going to get Kinley Elder, the Colors Day queen, with the foul. Kinley has two. First free throw up and good for Gravette. Puts it back to a three-point advantage. We await the second. It is true as well. In two-possession ball game for the Lions, and this allows them to set up that full court press that Prairie Grove's had trouble with, but Cameron Cash able to break it. She's going to take it to the hole, but nearly loses it. Ball will stay with Prairie Grove. Another deflected shot from Lexi Henry as the Lions have been active on the defensive end of the floor. Gravette going to try and make something happen. Wing three up. That one off the mark. Easy board for Henry. And the Tigers will try again. Looks like a 2-3 zone for the Gravette Lions. Prairie Grove going to try and shoot their way out of it. Kinley Elder draws a triple team. She goes up strong off the mark. But an offensive rebound. Basketball and a fresh 35 for Prairie Grove. Three on the way and bottom of the net. That time for Cameron Cash. Big three-pointer there. Brings it within a point. Closest it's been in this second half for Prairie Grove. Cameron has 13 on the day. Three on the way the other end. Off the mark and a board. This time for Ella Falk. Prairie Grove an opportunity to take the lead for the first time in quite some time. Cash going to drive to the basket. No, nope. Going to pull up and fire. Had an opportunity, a wide open opportunity at the basket. As Elder gets the offensive board, gets a couple of opportunities, and will go to the stripe for her trouble. As it's going to be the first foul on Alexa Parker of Gravette. Kinley has 5 points today. And two very big three throws in this third quarter. First one up, first one good. And we are tied once more with a minute 22 to go in this third quarter. Of course, Elder, like we mentioned, the Colors Day Queen. Her second one up and good as well. And your Prairie Grove Tigers back ahead by a point. First lead this half. As Coach Reed's girls have fought back in this one. The layup this time from Romine puts Gravette ahead. Lead going to seesaw back and forth. Cash able to break the trap. Prairie Grove stays alive. Three up on the way. Bottom of the net that time for Hope Kidd, the freshman, having a career night in her second start in Tiger Gym. Their second action in Tiger Gym on the varsity level, pardon. As it's a two-point lead, 45 seconds to go in the quarter. Prairie Grove looking for more. That time Henry able to get a hand to it, able to keep it alive. As it was going to Hope Kidd. Into the game will come Bella Barnes. She'll replace Kinley Elder. We have 35 seconds to go in this third quarter. And Prairie Grove looking for more. Able to get it into Falk. She's going to take a shot of her own. That one off the mark. Shot clock will turn off for the final 30 seconds in this third period of play. Gravette going to try and get the last shot of this quarter. Going to a 1-3-1 zone. Help will come from Gravette. Runner to the basket. Oh, and a late whistle. Had a bad foul to commit. Brooke Handel going to go to the line to shoot two shots for Gravette with 7.5 seconds to go in this third quarter. Again, join us on Tuesday night for our next broadcast of Prairie Grove Tiger basketball. We'll go live at 5:55 against the Berryville Bobcats. As the second one will go 1-2 at the line that time for Gravette. It's a one-point difference. Cash will get the ball inbound across the timeline. 5 seconds to go in the quarter. She's going to take it coast to coast. And the shot nearly falls for Bella Barnes, but we'll go to the fourth. Your Prairie Grove Tigers have retaken the lead, 36-35. More when we return.
Zing Broadband is a proud sponsor of area schools and is excited to offer incredible fast internet speeds. Our students can focus on what really matters, knowing that Zing Broadband can keep up with them. We recognize the hard work and dedication of our students and athletes, and we've built a network to deliver their demand. Zing Broadband proudly serves our local communities and supports all their endeavors.
Welcome back for the final quarter of play. It's Friday evening, January 13th. Thanks for joining us. I'm Stephen Blackston. Lynn, we'll be back in a moment as your Prairie Grove Tigers lead at home 36-35. Should be an exciting conclusion to Colors Day in Prairie Grove. Cameron Cash leads all Tigers with 13 points. Only player with more tonight are the 14 of Bryn Romine and Gravette. We get back underway for the final quarter of play. Miss Gravette trying to make something happen, but a traveling violation on Romine, the leading scorer in tonight's contest, will give the opportunity to Prairie Grove to extend the lead. Going to have to go 5 seconds left before a 10-second violation. Able to get across to Barnes. Miss Prairie Grove going to push the tempo down under the basket. Nice little find and in. Ella Falk, 38-35. Prairie Grove trying to pull out of the station in this fourth quarter. Cross court find. Gravette trying to make something happen. Up and in this time. That'll be Elsie of Gravette. Gets that one to go.
I apologize, Stephen. I come back and we give up a basket, but here comes Henry. I apologize to you and to, I got trapped, not really trapped, but our new mayor, Mayor David Falk, he was there. He and I were just talking a little business and some shop there, and so we. I'm sorry I took the third quarter off.
Oh no, it's completely fine. It's completely fine. No problem at all. As Ella, while you were gone, had a couple of big baskets, just one momentarily to get us underway in this fourth quarter.
And she's played, we were watching, and she was playing a big part on the boards. There's a turnover there by Lady Tigers. This is the kind of game I anticipated tonight with this ball game. Was I anticipated a lot of a close game. And if you think about it, I think the largest lead by either team has been 5 points. I think Gravette Lady Lions had a 5-point lead at one point.
And neither have really been able to get out of each other's way. And I was mentioning this in the third quarter, but Gravette is only a game better than Prairie Grove in the conference standings. They're 3-2. Prairie Grove's 2-3. So two teams that are on paper
pretty even. Like I said, they're evenly matched. And the one common opponent that they beat that we lost to was one that we let get away, which was Huntsville. You know, we had Huntsville on the ropes and let them get away that night. And then they hung on there. Prairie Grove's going to call a timeout. Let's stay with it here, Stephen. It was a great third quarter. Just because I was not here on the mic, I was observing it with our mayor. And now I feel like I'm name dropping. But I would tell you a funny story. Talking about name dropping. So everyone knows the great Dick Vitale. I've had the opportunity to meet him on several occasions. And one of the companies I worked for, he was one of our spokespeople, and I traveled with him, et cetera. But anyway, I'm not name-dropping him other than this. When I was with him, we start talking, right?
Mm-hmm.
And he goes, Lynn, why didn't you tell me you were there? I could have introduced you to Larry and Magic. And then he says, oh, yeah, and Coach Thompson was there. And he's name-dropping to me. And I'm like,
you're
Dick.
You're Dick Vitale.
I was like, Dick. I'm like, look, I'm going to name drop you. You don't have to name drop all these people to me.
You know, but to go circle back around to that point about that Huntsville game, and that's really the difference right now in the season.
Boy, that was almost a big-time shot. They're going to get Barnes for that foul. Now, the difference in the first half or second half when it comes to fouls, by this time in the first half,
shooting free throws.
You were shooting free throws. Now both teams, and I don't know if it's less fouls or the refs are letting them play a little more.
Yeah, it could be kind of either way. And honestly, both sides really haven't had a lot of opportunities, good opportunities at scoring. It's kind of been a discombobulated game in this second half.
Where was Sean? Oh, no. Bella Barnes, a little bit of a mental error that time.
And that'll bring Kinley Elder back in the game to replace her.
5.5 minutes to go in the game. And the Lady Tigers holding to a one-point advantage, trying to get it inside. And there is Romine. Then she knocks down the three. She's now got 17 in the game. They are up by two. If we go down by four, I'm going to go off the mic again and go talk to someone else and get us back in the game. I do my part. Kidd kicks it out to Cash. Cash to Falk. Falk goes baseline. Shot on the way. No good. Elder there to clean it up. She's going to get fouled. And she's going to be fouled by Parker.
And Elder in the second quarter, or second half, pardon, is really coming to her own at the free throw line, getting some offensive rebounds, doing the dirty work down in the paint.
I think last time at the line, she was one of two. Let's hope she can knock them both down this time. First one's on the way. She got it. 42-41, 4:55 to go in the game. Queen Elder again at the line. This time she knocks it down. And just like when the game started, we're all tied up with 4:50 to go in the ball game. Parker, long three off the back of the rim. I thought she was going to make a liar out of me there for a minute. And now here comes Kidd quickly down the floor. Off her foot. Oh, I think she just over-anticipated a little bit that time.
Yeah, I think that's one of those situations like in football when you hear about the receivers, they're looking to see where they're going to go before the ball gets there. I think she saw the basket opportunity and just forgot about the basketball.
42 all, 4:38 to go in the ball game. And now Elsie going against Falk. Falk lays it up and in. Elsie. Now what we have to do here, Steven, is when they get a basket, we got to match them. We need to match baskets and get a stop here in a minute and get that lead back.
Certainly do. The second half, the offense has come alive for Prairie Grove. They've been able to maintain the touching distance, able to claw back into the game. Like you mentioned, had a lead for a little bit as well.
Elder, shot. No good. Rebound goes into the hands of Elsie. 4 minutes to go in the game, 44-42. Three-pointer on the way. No good. Somebody don't watch for it. Good night that we sat there and watched them get the rebound. No one went to the ball. That's tough. And now Washawn pulls up, shot on the way, and she gets it. That's 15-footer right at the free throw line. That's a basket that we should not have given up there. That was they got a second chance. We stood, we had two or three girls just stand and look.
Yeah, it was flat-footed all around for the rebounders in the vicinity.
And Kidd, tough break that time. Oh, gosh, if we go down six, I'm getting off the air. I'm a little superstitious.
A little stitious?
A little bit. Come on now. I shouldn't tell lies like that. Oh, that's – yeah. Yep. Ella may have been moving that time a little, but there was enough of an out push of the arm that's going to get her. I think if it would have just been a pure charge where
the feet
may have gone the other way, but she let that arm extend a little bit, and that helped us get the call. 46-42. Lady Tiger's really neat. Boy, she got away with a little bit of a carry. Cash goes baseline, kicks it. Luckily Lady Tigers got a break on that one.
Yeah, those cross-court passes this late in the game get more dangerous and more dangerous. Each trip down the floor, the legs are more tired, arms are more tired. Those passes don't have quite the same zip on them.
Prairie Grove's going to take a timeout. Let's take it, go to our sponsors. We'll be back for the final 2:55.
Kimball Mechanical Systems specializes in installing plumbing, HVAC, and electrical systems in mid to large housing projects, including subdivisions, apartment complexes, and military housing. Kimball wants to partner with more people who want to earn a good living in the skilled trades. Kimball is the largest mechanical contractor in Arkansas with 8 other locations nationwide. Kimball is proud to have won Arkansas's Best Places to Work 5 years in a row. They provide excellent benefits and an amazing family-oriented culture. For great job opportunities, check out kmsjobs.com.
All right, we're back. 2:55 to go in the game. Lady Tigers trail by four. Had a lead to start this quarter. But Gravette getting a couple of second-time chances, and they have been able to get the lead. Ella Falk takes it. Now let's see what Lady Tigers going to do coming out of this timeout. There's Henry. And, whoa, wow. Ella, no good, rebound. And the Lady Tigers, wow, they needed that. And with 2:35, 2:36 now to go in the game, you really need a basket right here because they can eat up. You know, after this, it'll go under 2 minutes.
Yeah, the next possession will.
Because you, if you're Gravette, you can sit back. Wow. Got to get it in. There's Henry. Wow.
Yeah, she's had a couple of those where.
Henry, free throw, got it.
I was just going to say, there's a couple of times there with Cash. She's thought about it. This time, bails her out with Lexi Henry on the free throw line jumper.
44-46. Need a defensive stop here. And Elders are going to. They're going to call on the floor, I think. I think Prairie Grove's going to get the ball on the side. After she got the steal, I think Sean picks up the foul. I think that's going to be her third foul. And that's a 1-1. That's a big foul.
It certainly is.
Now, Queen Elder needs to knock these two down.
Yeah, score without the clock running. That is big point opportunity at the moment.
Elder got it. She's made the last four in a row. And now she needs to knock this one down and tie it up. With 2:19, we're all tied up. Wow. And we're in the 1-1, which could be big down the stretch because we've got three fouls to give. Need a stop here. And they're going to get a foul. That was a quick foul. I opened my big mouth and we get a foul.
Yeah, that now goes down to two fouls to give with that, you know, approaching the 2 minute mark.
That's such a cheesy foul to give up right there, too. All right, make the stop right here, girls. Man, Elsie's begging for the ball down there. She was open, too. Nice take that time. And Handel gets that. Now it's back to a two-point lead for Gravette. Cash gives it up to Nall. Henry. Nall. Elder. Goes up. She's going to get blocked. Nice block by Wishon. That's clean. That's good clean. Walk. Should have been a walk. She's rolling around. Ah. Elsie was rolling around and should have been a walk. Now you got to stop her defensively. I don't think you got a foul here.
No, still plenty of time. You know, a minute 20 to go in the game. Maybe the next time down the floor.
And a turnover.
Yeah, depending on the result of this possession, will determine whether you start playing the foul game.
If we can score here, you definitely don't have to. This is a close one. Then Lady Tigers, I think if they can hang on to the victory, great victory. If they lose tonight, I think I would look at probably the second and third chances that the Lady Lions had tonight on the offensive end. Gets it inside, Falk, out, Nall, three-pointer, on the way, bottom, yes, 49-48, 50 seconds to go in the game, now we got a game, hey! A defensive stop here, get it under 35 seconds. Parker with the ball, gets it out to Romine, and it's going to be a foul, and it's going to be on the floor, so... A break for Prairie Grove, 35 second clock.
What, 3/10 is the difference, it looks like.
And into the game comes Kidd for Nall. 35.3, and Kidd, that's our.
She fouls out.
That's Nall's fifth foul. I was wondering why she's coming out with five fouls. And with Sean Parker. Hey! Whoa! He brings it up. The Gravette fans aren't going to like it. I actually thought it was. Now, the one thing that Falk did She had position, but she was almost set up like a lineman on a pass block.
I mean, she was standing there, too. I mean, Gravette went right at her.
But Falk, it
she
looked
was ready for it.
She was ready for it, but she was kind of in that position. But great job. Now, the Lady Tigers, they've got good ball handlers. You got Cash, you got Kidd, you got Henry in the game. You also have Elder, who does a pretty good job in Falk. So all those girls do a pretty good job handling the ball. They'll be putting full court press here.
Yeah.
So, you know, and Coach Reed has two timeouts. So, and I'm losing my voice. Oh, man.
Yeah, well, and that's the thing. I think you'll see from Gravette, if they can't get a 10-second backcourt, they get across the timeline, they're going to look to foul because – we've seen tonight in that first quarter and a little bit in the second quarter, Prairie Grove's had trouble breaking the press. Obviously, Gravette going to crank it up to 11 coming out of this timeout.
There's been some pretty even score tonight for Prairie Grove. Cash with 13, Henry with 10, Elder with 11, Romine with 17, Washam with 10 for the Lady Lions, and Handel has 11. There's Henry with the ball. Gets it back to Falk. And Falk, oh, wow, gets it to Kidd.
And Coach,
that was smart. He was afraid she was going to travel with it. He didn't. And that's a good timeout by Coach Reed, 23.7. I burned a little bit of clock there.
And I agree. You know, good timeout as well because you get the ball down to your freshman. This is only her second game of action here in Tiger Gym on the varsity level. I think that's a wise timeout, and obviously you don't get to take them with you. You can draw up your best inbounds play and have an opportunity to ice this bad boy.
Well, what you want here, if I'm Gravette, I'll be honest with you. I don't think I foul right away. I think I try for maybe 4 seconds or so. If I don't get it, then you got to foul because you're going to need – because if they miss the one-on-one, you can go down there and win the game. If they make it, it gives you time to get this thing into overtime. So I think you got to try for the steal after that first 3 seconds, 4 seconds. You got to go ahead and get that foul in.
And it's going to be an exciting finish regardless.
Yes, it will. It's been an exciting game tonight.
It certainly has. It didn't start out very offensively heavy, but, man, it has turned a corner, almost 100 combined points between the two schools.
And Coach Reed takes his last time out. He was afraid she wasn't going to get in. And Coach Reed, what you got to do here, I think you got to set up something that somebody comes off a pick so that you've got
an easy
open person. Because you don't have that luxury now. And it could – I mean, Cash is – that's probably the third time tonight that she's come close to that five-second call. And I thought she had a little more time, but Coach Reed wasn't going to risk it.
No, and certainly not in this situation this late in the game with this much on the line. But, yeah, no, Cash, she's thought about it. She's thought about it and has flirted with disaster on the inbounds play.
So this time it looks like Elder's going to bring the ball in.
And that's not necessarily a bad idea. Elder's the tallest Tiger on the floor as well, able to see over most of the Lions.
Coach Reed needs to get off court. I love him. I love him to death. He might not want to be that far out there. Coach Pittman will be working those officials to get a tech called on him. Here it is. And
a little foul and grab it. That's almost better.
Well,
we'll see, actually, thinking about it.
She needs to knock down the first one.
Yeah.
Ella Falk at the line. That's 4 fouls now. Remind, this is a big free throw from Falk. Falk on the way. Got it. Ella Falk gives the Lady Tigers a 2-point lead. Timeout by Coach Pittman. Let's take it with him this time. 23.7, Tigers up by 2.
Kimball Mechanical Systems specializes in installing plumbing, HVAC, and electrical systems in mid to large housing projects, including subdivisions, apartment complexes, and military housing. Kimball wants to partner with more people who want to earn a good living in the skilled trades. Kimball is the largest mechanical contractor in Arkansas with 8 other locations nationwide. Kimball is proud to have won Arkansas's Best Places to Work 5 years in a row. They provide excellent benefits and an amazing family-oriented culture. For great job opportunities, check out KMSJobs.com.
It's a big free throw, Lynn, as we get back underway.
Yeah, it is. It's a big free throw, because if you can do that, I don't want to say you're guaranteed, but at least on the next possession, the worst you can do is a tie. And that's a big thing here. So, Coach back out, getting close to the free throw line again. We'll have to have a little conversation with Coach Reed. You know, it's his first year here. I've got a chance to talk to him a couple times. Really, really nice guy. Falk knocks down the second one, 51-48. I would almost – well, no, I was going to say – now, you got to back up here. Not got to cover that three. And they got an open three. Off the mark. Ball's out of bounds.
Tiger basketball.
Prairie Grove's got it. And the Lady Tigers with 11 seconds. Now you just got to get the ball in. And that's going to force a foul. Elder over to Kidd. Kidd out there. That's going to do it. The Lady Tigers pull it out. The final score, Prairie Grove Lady Tigers 51, the Gravette Lady Lions 48, go to 3-3 in the conference, tied with Gravette. And a good game tonight, Stephen, leading score for Prairie Grove, Cash with 13, Henry with 10, Elder with 11, Kidd, the freshman, with 8, Ella Falk with 6. Leading score for the Lady Lions was Romine with 17, Wishon had 10. And Handel had 11. Well, we want to thank Lark for being on the camera tonight. Steven, another great job by you and Southern Sports Network. For our crew, I'm Lynn Gregson. Have a great night, and go Tigers!